Welcome to Free Talk Live. Join us here toll-free to bring up whatever you want to discuss. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us anytime you want online over at freetalklive.com. And the us tonight includes me, Ian.
And Derek J.
And Derek and I, freshly back from the Porcupine Freedom Festival. I guess now it's been more than 24 hours since we've been back. But
yeah,
you know, but it's been great. It really was a wonderful week. I heard you recounting some of your week last night on the Freedom Fiends as I was sort of in studio lurking, listening into the program. You host Freedom Fiends. It's another nationally syndicated talk radio program with a pro-freedom viewpoint on late Sunday, early Monday.
Yeah.
Early Monday morning, overnights.
And I was talking about how much Porkfest was like heaven on earth, a week that I cannot miss for
anything.
It's
wonderful. It really is. And you had the added benefit of having somebody that you would just found absolutely wonderful that you met there.
Yes, I was swept off my feet this Porkfest.
That's so cool. And you were describing it as very unexpected, as I suppose all of those meetings, those chance meetings with somebody who you really gel with on an attractive kind of basis, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Very cool. So a big win for you at Porkfest. And I think, you know, if you go to the Porcupine Freedom Festival and you don't have a good time, it's probably your fault.
There's too much to do that's so much fun. All these overlapping events. I mean, I didn't make it to half of what I expected to.
I never even expect to go to the actual events anymore. It seems like those are for the new people who, they don't know.
Yeah, right. It's a good way to start meeting people. But for me, I mean, I was meeting people and reconnecting with others throughout the entire week. So it's not to say, you know, because I missed the events that I wasn't having any fun. Far from it.
Oh, yeah.
I was packing it all in. Barely slept the entire week. Was having so much fun.
I gotta say, I did get enough sleep. I wasn't strung out. There was one Porkfest, I think, 2 years ago where I came back and I was so tired. I probably shouldn't have been driving. That wasn't good.
Yeah.
This year, it definitely did better. I wasn't absolutely wiped afterwards. Like, sometimes I'll come back from the Porcupine Freedom Festival, which, for those that don't know, is a yearly camping festival thrown in the North White Mountains of New Hampshire by the Free State Project to kind of show off what it's like to live around a community of people, but a community of people who love freedom for a week. And, you know, a lot of times I'll come back and there's a social event that we have called Social Sundays here. And I've missed that before just because I've been so exhausted that I've just passed out. But yesterday I actually was doing good, stayed up late just like I normally would. And it was good.
Same.
I feel like it was a good week. You know, just a nice, for me, it's like a working vacation. I guess to you, it's similar because you host a few different radio shows while you're there. And so, you know, you're kind of on and then off and then on again. And it's just a different week. Everything's at a different pace than it normally is. You've got, if you want to go from one point of the campsite to another one, you've got to set aside an hour just because you're going to likely encounter people that want to just kind of pull you aside and talk. And
That's going to happen. Sure. If you're going even just to grab a bite to eat, you might encounter several people who hold you up on your way. No, it's all voluntary, of course.
Sure. I could always just, you know, power through if I really need to get somewhere.
Yeah.
That's certainly possible. But, you know, if you've got a list of three things to do, three really simple things to do at the Porcupine Freedom Festival, sometimes I won't even get through all three of them in one day. Even though I've got the full day to accomplish these basic tasks, sometimes I'll find myself at the end of the day having not done what I had hoped that I would set out to do.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's usually various reasons. I got distracted by A, B, or C, or, you know, the internet wasn't working where I was, and so it's always interesting.
And I got to say, this was the final year for Buzz's Big Gay Dance Party. And
she went out on top.
It was a terrific finale. She sure did. Always manages to top herself and did that again this year.
It was interesting.
The highlight of my week.
Buzz was concerned about the theft of the stripper pole.
She thought that was going to have an impact. And it may have, but it didn't seem
I saw her party. Her recap she posted on her Facebook page today. She felt that it was actually a better party because it didn't have it, there was more room for people to dance and to socialize or whatever. And
I found the stripper pole to be intimidating in in past years. I just stayed away from
it. I wasn't interested in it personally. I mean, you know, it's fun to watch people, but...
Yeah, I enjoy those who are courageous, more courageous than I am, who have some skills on the pole, but I just stayed away.
Yeah, I have no skills.
And it's a lot of pressure, too, because there are cameras there at Buzz's party.
Lots
There's cameras everywhere at Porkfest. But especially if you're doing something showy, like dancing on a pole, that's going to end up on the internet.
Yeah, it was my first Buzz's Big Gay Dance Party. I got up on one of the boxes and started dancing
there. This was the first time you did that?
No, I've done that year after year. But at the first one, people tipped me.
Whoa, were they putting bills in your costume?
Yeah, I got bills, and I had this one lady walk up and give me an ounce of silver.
Like,
I walked out of there with $35 worth of tips at the end of the thing. Unfortunately, it didn't happen any year after that, but I still enjoy doing that. I can do that. Like, I don't feel like I need any real talent to get up on a box and dance. You just have to have the willingness to do it. And it was cool because she actually changed her Ms. Porcupole award to the best box dancer. I forget what she called it, but something
Ms.
like
Hotbox.
That. Ms. Hotbox, yeah. And I forget who won, but man, it was great. It was a great contest. It was a great party. And really, it peaked the event, I think, because after Buzz's Big Gay Dance Party, the whole event just seemed to wind down, even over the next whole day.
It's weird, yeah, because it was such an intense, fun event, it seemed like nothing after that could really be better than that. I mean, it was so good. Yeah, everything after that, even though the music and dancing, the fire, burning a wooden porcupine, everything that happened after that, there was a lot going on Saturday, but it did seem to decrescendo.
So obviously, you know, we could continue to reflect on this amazing event. There's actually, I'm surprised that there isn't more media coverage about it.
Yeah.
I've been looking and looking over the last few days. I know CNN was there last week to shoot a piece, but I don't think that's come out yet. So
I would expect to see some news articles. I remember even during the winter version of this festival, the Liberty Forum, there are articles being published almost daily while it's happening, and that didn't occur this time.
It didn't. There was an article from the Union Leader, which is the big newspaper in New Hampshire, prior to Porkfest. There was one in the middle of the week at Porkfest, and there has not been one to wrap it up.
It's pretty quiet.
There's an article by Julie Borowski, who is one of the speakers this year at the Porcupine Freedom Festival. She's a YouTube video person, and there's also Jacob Hornberger from the Future of Freedom Foundation. I put up a quick little article at freekeen.com that links to all three of those, but man, I've been looking, and maybe everybody's just still kind of recovering, and they haven't had a chance to write what they're going to write yet.
Why do you think... So one of the Union Leader articles described this Porkfest as particularly mellow or low key. Well, you know, why do you think it was described that way? Was this a more low key Porkfest than ones you've experienced in the past?
I don't think so. I mean, there were fewer people there, but only by a couple hundred.
Oh, really? There were fewer than last year?
Yes, there were about 200 fewer attendees this year.
Wow. To what do you think that's attributed?
I don't know. It was down from 1,500 to 1,300. I suspect it was the price, because they did raise the price by not quite 50%. It used to be, I think it was $70.
Wow, that's a substantial increase.
Yeah. I think it was $70 for a ticket last year, and then $100, like full price, the full
early bird was still very reasonable.
Well, it's always cheaper to get early bird tickets. But I mean, way, way back, it was way cheaper to attend the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
I see. All right.
So maybe they
need a little bit of price discovery happening there.
Yeah, maybe they need to find the right balance between price and attendance. And, you know, it could have just been an off year. I mean, for instance, Keenvention's second year was actually slightly less turnout than the first year.
Yeah.
And
I'll bet the Edward Snowden revelations had something to do with the popularity of Porkfest maybe in 2013, when more people are keyed into the freedom issues.
Could
like
be.
It doesn't seem like there's a big freedom event going on this year.
Yeah, I guess next year is the election. So
right,
maybe
so that would
more
be more popular. Yeah, I would think so.
Well, that's as good a speculation as any. I mean, it's really hard to say. You know, you'd have to actually interview people to get their reasons.
Like an exit poll.
Yeah, why didn't you go, you know, talk to the people from last year and ask them why they didn't come back? A lot of people don't come year after year because it's expensive, right? Like, it's not a cheap thing.
If they're traveling,
To drive or to fly across the country. And then if you're flying, you've got to buy all your camping equipment or you're renting a hotel room. It's an investment. And anyway, we'll come back with more here. 855-450-FREE. There's an update from Greece and more on the way. Free Talk Live.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
Discover how deep your American roots go for free this 4th of July weekend. Go to TryAncestry.com to get free access through July 5th. Visit TryAncestry.com anytime this Wednesday through Sunday, and you'll have free access to our collection of records from the original 13 colonies and with a new visual story experience. Celebrate this 4th of July and take advantage of this free access weekend. Visit TryAncestry.com. That's TryAncestry.com. TryAncestry.com.
All loans subject to Ondex Corp. Approval. Must be business at least 1 year to apply.
Attention, small business owners needing financing. Are you too busy running your business to deal with the slow lending process of your bank? Are you frustrated at the paperwork and delays just trying to get a decision? Then you need Ondex, the A+ Better Business Bureau rated small business experts, where our simple application process takes as little as 10 minutes and funding could be available in just one business day. At Ondex, we focus on your business operation and cash flow, not just your personal credit score. And we're ready to help with loans of up to $250,000. True business loans, not credit card advances. OnDeck provides financing to a wide variety of small businesses like restaurants, plumbing, landscaping, freight trucking, and healthcare providers. If you're frustrated with the paperwork and long decision times of traditional lenders, contact OnDeck. Funding could be available in just one business day. OnDeck is publicly listed on the New York Stock Exchange and has provided over $2 billion to small businesses like yours. So go to OnDeckLending.com today or call 800-293-6819. That's 800-293-6819.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And right now, you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us here toll-free. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And want to inform you about ExpressCoin. That is where you can go to get Bitcoin. Now might be a good time for it. Now, of course, anything can happen. You know, the price of Bitcoin. The hell was that? I'm going to mute that because I don't know what that was. Anyway, the price of Bitcoin Oh, I bet I know what that was. I've got one of those Bitcoin map websites where it shows the little coins.
Yeah, Bitcoin Tone.
This one's called FiatLeak. FiatLeak.com.
Yeah, I'm familiar. And it makes a sound and based on where Bitcoin is going around the world. So if someone in China is exchanging fiat for Bitcoin, you can see the Bitcoin move into China.
Oh, okay. I just saw, I was looking at the page here and it says it will play a sound when the rate is 20 Bitcoin per second, meaning that there's 20 Bitcoins being bought, I guess, in that second around the world.
It's quite a lot.
Well, anyway, it's a cool little map that shows you where in the world the Bitcoins are going to at any given moment in time. And it's kind of a cool visual representation of what's happening in the Bitcoin universe. I'm not sure how accurate it is because right now it's only showing Bitcoins going to China and the U.S., which doesn't make any sense. You would think there'd be other Bitcoins going elsewhere around the world. But again, I don't know what they're tracking.
Yeah, but that's at any given second. So, you know, right. you'll see it change throughout the day.
I want to see them go to Greece. That's what I'm looking for here. So anyway, I was going to tell you how to get Bitcoin because it might be a good time for it. Now, you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. You don't know what's going to happen in the next hour. Bitcoin's price may go down. You know, you might wake up tomorrow morning and it might be down. You don't know. But one thing's for sure, during the Cyprus situation where the government went in and gave a haircut, as they called it, to every single bank account in the country, there was a big spike in the price of Bitcoin when that was happening. And right now, with this financial calamity hitting Greece, the price of Bitcoin has been going up again. Well, will it keep going up? And for how long will it continue to go up? I don't know the answers to those questions. But either way, you might want to consider getting some Bitcoin, and you can do that over at ExpressCoin.com. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and ExpressCoin can also help you get other cryptocurrencies like Dogecoin and Litecoin, and you can do it from the U.S. or Canada. They've got an app that you can download if you'd like, or you can just use their website, ExpressCoin.com, money order or check. That's how you send your cash in and turn it into Bitcoins in your Bitcoin wallet. So once again, ExpressCoin.com. Our toll-free number tonight, if you want to join us here, maybe you want to give us your Porkfest recap. You're certainly welcome to talk about that. It's an amazing event that no one who loves liberty should miss. At least, you know, you got to go at least once in your life to the Porcupine Freedom Festival, I think. And preferably, you should come to New Hampshire and live here 52 weeks a year rather than just that one. But Porkfest is a good little taste of that. So there's other stuff to talk about here tonight besides our Porkfest reflections. And Derek J., you and I both had a similar story, and I'll let you share it. It's about the gay marriage ruling, which apparently the Supreme Court, this was something that happened during Porkfest. I feel so disconnected from the world. But one of the few headlines I did hear about while I was at Porkfest was the Supreme Court ruled in favor of gay marriage, which essentially legalizes it around the United States. Is that right?
Yeah, and to me, this was like, yawn. I don't care.
As a gay man
who follows politics, I did not care about this ruling. It was not a big deal to me because I don't wait for permission from men in faraway lands to, you know, allow me to get married. Like, I expect to get married sometime in my life, but I never really have been confronted with any of the difficulties about marriage. Like, they say there are certain rights and tax benefits to being married. You can share health care. So I guess that's a big deal, but it's never been an issue for me. So I don't see why this is relevant to my life. I know a lot of gay people are celebrating this as a victory. They're very happy about it. But for me, where it actually does intersect with my life is right here. According to BearingArms.com, the Supreme Court ruling on same-sex marriage mandates nationwide concealed carry reciprocity. It actually has implications for your gun freedoms. Hmm. So this story from Bob Owens, he writes, if you're following any of the various media outlets this morning, you're probably aware of that the U.S. Supreme Court has just extended gay marriage to all 50 states. And then he has a reference to it that the Supreme Court ruled Friday all same-sex couples have the right to marry nationwide, an historic decision that invalidates gay marriage bans in more than a dozen states. Gay and lesbian couples already can marry in 36 states and the District of Columbia, and the court's ruling on Friday means that in the remaining 14 states in the South and Midwest, they'll have to stop enforcing their bans on same-sex marriage. The outcome is the culmination of 2 decades of Supreme Court litigation over marriage and gay rights generally. And you can read the whole ruling, but it all comes down to one important paragraph. The 14th Amendment, this is a quote from the Supreme Court's decision.
Okay.
They write, the 14th Amendment requires a state to license marriage between two people of the same sex. The fundamental liberties protected by the 14th Amendment's due process clause extend to certain personal choices central to individual dignity and autonomy. See how this is intersecting with gun freedoms? Including intimate choices defining personal identity and beliefs. So you could construe this to mean same-sex marriage or somebody's right to self-defense, to defend themselves, to conceal carry a firearm. If these rights exist in 36 different states and not the 14, you would think that this Supreme Court ruling now makes it so that those bans or those may-issue states have become shall-issue states. You see what I'm saying?
Can you read the paragraph again for me?
Yeah, so the fundamental liberties protected by the 14th Amendment's due process clause extend to certain personal choices central to individual dignity and autonomy. So that's, I think, the most important clause of the paragraph. The court used Section 1 of the 14th Amendment to justify its arguments, and this is, for those who aren't familiar with the 14th Amendment, this is what it says. And
yeah, thank you. I was going to ask about that.
All persons born or naturalized in the U.S. and subject to the jurisdiction thereof are citizens of the United States and the state wherein they reside. Now, you and I, Ian, may disagree with this definition.
Yeah, I don't like being a citizen. I don't want their protection.
But this is what it reads. No state shall make or enforce any law which shall abridge the privileges or immunities of citizens of the United States. Nor shall any state deprive any person of life, liberty, or property without due process of law, nor deny to any person within its jurisdiction the equal protection of the laws. And so this to me is saying that if I have a concealed carry license in the state of New Hampshire.
Which you don't.
Which I don't. But if I did, and hopefully I soon will.
They're trying to stop you from getting one. You're going to the Supreme Court to attempt to overturn a judge's decision against you.
That's right. Yeah, it's a ridiculous decision. But if I did have that concealed carry license in New Hampshire, and I wanted to go visit family in New Jersey, let's say, then my concealed carry license would be reciprocal, despite New Jersey currently saying it's not.
And that's your interpretation of what the Supreme Court said
about
the gay marriage thing. I'm not a lawyer,
but that is my interpretation. I say I now have that freedom.
How do you put that to the test?
You do it.
Who will do this? 855-450-FREE.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Anytime, any place, anywhere. Radio remains the most intimate of all forms of media. At home, at work, in the car, on smartphones. Over 90% of consumers still listen to radio every week. That makes choosing radio as a place to advertise your business one of the best decisions you can make. Email advertise@gcnlive.com and partner up with an experienced GCN representative. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and of course, we'll take your calls about whatever you want to discuss. You just dial on in toll-free and join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Derek J.
Derek J's got himself a website. It's thederekj.com. Derek, yeah. What will our listeners find on your website?
Well, you've heard a lot of fun about Porkfest. Now you can see it for yourself. All of my videos will be uploaded tonight. I'll be uploading videos. I'm doing that right now.
How many videos did you record at Porkfest?
About 3 hours worth of video.
Oh my goodness.
So there's lots to watch that's going up on YouTube tonight.
Wow.
If you missed Porkfest, you can live vicariously through my camera at thederekj.com.
Cool. So give me an example of one thing you captured with your camera at the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
There was a weird bill stamping machine. I don't know if you saw this, but it was like a Rube Goldberg machine where there's lots of ridiculous, pointless steps that make a there's a politician who yells at you and all sorts of fun things. There's also a voting machine that was very unique and a vending machine that accepted Bitcoin and dispensed bullets and silver
and pregnancy tests and apparently there was like a marijuana drug test in there.
Yes, there
all
was
kinds of weird stuff.
Yes, there was.
That thing is the coolest machine.
Yeah, you could even put in dollar bills and get your change in Bitcoin. It was very unique. And
so effectively, it was a Bitcoin vending machine. So if you put in, you could put in
$50, buy a $1 item, get $49 in
worth
Bitcoin.
Worth of Bitcoin back. Yeah, exactly.
It was very cool.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts. More on this, these allegations from gun rights advocates. And I like what you're saying here, Derek J., and I hope your legal interpretation is correct, that this recent Supreme Court ruling for gay marriage is also a Supreme Court ruling by either accident or whatever in favor of gun rights and gun licensing being essentially an existing gun license being reciprocated by all 50 states, which currently is not the case.
Yeah.
Each state seems to currently decide which other states they'll recognize the gun permits. So I've actually got a response article from somebody on the left who has got something to say about this. We'll check in with that here in a moment. Your calls are first, though. 855-450-FREE is our number. Ron is in North Carolina listening to Talk Radio 850 in Durham. Hey, Ron.
Hey, Ron.
Hey, fellas. Hopefully my stupid phone here is working good enough. Can you hear me all right?
Yeah. It's all right. Go ahead.
All right. Yeah. I was just listening to you guys talk about that Port Fest all last week and living vicariously. I'm going to check out that video and stuff for sure. And I'm definitely going to plan to make it up there next year.
Good
try
plan.
To tie it in with a couple days in Laconia and then carry it over.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You called last week, right, to say you're going to go to Bike Week out in Laconia, which is a huge event.
Woo!
And I think it's usually like the week before.
Yeah, and I was just curious. For that $100, what do you get? Does that give you the camping pass? Or that
no, you'd have to pay to camp on top of that. So the $100 is the ticket into the Porcupine Freedom Festival for all 7 days. So, it doesn't break down to very much.
Right, right. And I didn't know if it included the camping and whatnot as well.
No, I think camping is like $35 a night, but it's been a while since I've been camping, so I don't honestly know the price.
Okay, all right. Also, do you plan on doing any advertising? I was kind of surprised to hear you say that the attendance was down this year.
Yeah, well, I mean, we had promoted it on Free Talk Live, and there were a number of Free Talk Live listeners who were in attendance. It's just, not everything can grow every single year. I mean, I don't think that there weren't 200 people there this year. I mean, it went down from 1,500 to 1,300. That's still a very large event, and it's still a successful event, no doubt about it.
Yeah, with the election going to be heating up, I wonder if any of the potential presidential candidates would have the balls to show up there.
Oh, I don't expect you would see any anybody besides Vermin Supreme and maybe Gary Johnson. Gary Johnson's been to the Porcupine Freedom Festival, actually, I think on more than one occasion.
Yeah.
So I guess the answer is some would, but not the ones who have any chance of actually winning.
Let's get Donald Trump there.
Yeah.
Let's not
have a good time.
That would be cool. I mean, something get a little bit of national publicity or something. You know what I mean? Hell, it sounds like it's an awesome thing, and I really support your guys' cause. And, I would just like to see it grow into, Woodstock once a year or something.
Ron, thanks for your call. We'll see you next year at Porkfest. Appreciate hearing from you tonight.
All right.
Wouldn't it be great to see Rick Santorum at the Big Gay Dance Party?
That would be pretty hilarious, although he'd probably have to be wearing a mask or something like that. It's your theory that Rick Santorum, who is a former presidential candidate,
is gay.
Is a gay man.
Yes.
And you know this because you
are a gay man.
And he
travels with a lover. Yes. And I know,
you know the
through
signs.
Telepathy, we know each other. There's, an invisible gaydar that happens.
Now,
and
this Santorum guy,
we were in the same room,
would never admit to something like this, but you got a vibe from his staffer.
Saw his lover, one of his staffers or whatever he was. He
his
didn't
company.
Seem to be doing any work. He was traveling with him during the 2012 election,
literally in the same car, right? Like was getting in the back of the cruiser or whatever they were driving, not cruiser, but SUV thing.
And his wife was not with him.
Very suspicious.
Anyway, just throwing a rumor out there.
Isn't he in the video? You can see him briefly in the video where we confront Santorum and Keene, and we yell at
the
Santorum.
Lover that I'm referencing is in the video where you ask Santorum if he has ever Googled himself.
Right.
Outside of the Keene library here.
Great video. You should go and see that. If you enjoy a good, fun, political ambush video, that is one of the better ones. The Santorum Have You Googled Yourself video.
Yeah.
So our toll-free number tonight, you can join us here on the radio waves, 855-450-FREE is the number. Here is a response, Derek, to the article that you read. Now, there are a bunch of stories that are sort of the same ilk that you read. You just selected one from, what was it, defendyourself.whatever?
BearingArms.com.
There's a bunch of these things. You go out there, and usually they're kind of put out there in this attitude of, here's one of the headlines from BizPack Review. Gun rights groups find a side to gay marriage ruling that will make liberal heads explode. And it's like, screw you liberals is usually the attitude of the articles here.
Right.
Whereas, of course, you are a gay guy and you support gun rights. So if these interpretations are correct, it's kind of win-win for you.
Yeah, that would make conservatives' heads explode.
Yeah, exactly. So now here's a different story from MediaMatters.org. This is more of a lefty organization.
Yeah.
Headline here, conservative media argue same-sex marriage ruling creates constitutional right to carry a gun in public.
Good. Can't we both win? Can't we all just celebrate this as a victory, both the gays and the gun rights people?
Conservative media used the Supreme Court decision affirming that marriage is a fundamental right of all Americans to argue that the Constitution also requires states to recognize concealed carry permits issued by other states. But the Supreme Court has never held that carrying a gun in public is a fundamental right. On June 26, the Supreme Court issued a decision in Oberger...
Wait, what? The Supreme Court has never
decided
that...
This is the claim of Media Matters.
Carrying a gun in public is a right?
The claim from Media Matters is that the Supreme Court has never held that carrying a gun in public is a fundamental right.
Huh.
Now, I don't know if that's a true interpretation either, right? This is just one side versus the other side.
So you have the right to bear arms, but not in public, is what they're
Right, and you would expect there have been laws and prohibitions on guns that have been challenged previously.
That's interesting.
They'll get to a reference here in a moment.
All right.
On June 26, the Supreme Court issued a decision in Obergefell versus Hodges, holding that the 14th Amendment requires that states issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples. Conservative media and the NRA quickly seized on the decision to draw a parallel with concealed carry reciprocity, a top federal priority of the NRA. Reciprocity legislation, also known as federally mandated concealed carry, would force states to recognize permits to carry concealed guns issued by other states, regardless of what the issuing state's standards are for issuing permits. Because as you know, it's much easier to get a concealed carry permit in a place like New Hampshire than it is in, say, Florida or New York. Well, theoretically, you were denied in New Hampshire, but generally it's much easier in New Hampshire. I mean, I looked at the Florida process, and there's like a huge stack of papers and all kinds of ridiculous requirements. In New Hampshire, you just fill out one form. Now, whether it's approved or not is another question. But we'll get into that here in a moment. And what are the lefties saying in response? I'll share it coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key Liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenevention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenevention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenevention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Help get LRN.fm into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
We're back now with more Free Talk Live. You can share your thoughts with us. 855-450-FREE. Look, I'm no attorney, but one thing I know about attorneys is they disagree on things. And so I suspect there are a number of attorneys out there with different opinions about exactly what the Supreme Court ruling means when it comes to the claim that, well, this gay marriage ruling that ensures that gay marriage is going to be spread throughout all 50 states somehow is also going to mean that reciprocity on gun permits will be recognized in all 50 states.
Isn't the point of a Supreme Court ruling to establish more clarity surrounding the law?
Well, I guess in theory, but it's only for a moment, and then everybody else starts to speculate about what the decision really means.
Hmm.
And only time will tell, and multiple more other Supreme Court cases will tell before you can really narrow down what happens. And then, of course, what we see frequently is the courts will decide something, but then the police will ignore it anyway. So, like, you know, your right to record the police seems pretty firmly established, but yet police will still continue to harass and threaten and arrest people for using video cameras. So even when the Supreme Court or high-level courts say things, frequently it doesn't really have an effect on the way things happen on the ground level of government administration. So there is that. Share your thoughts with us, though, tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Before we go on, though, I want to talk a little bit about Peacekeeper. Derek J., you're a big fan of the Peacekeeper app.
Yes.
I like the concept. I really wanted to like the Peacekeeper app, but there were just a few bugs that were killers for me.
Yeah.
And fortunately, the people who are behind Peacekeeper have acknowledged those problems, and they have a plan to squash those bugs. They want to release Peacekeeper 2.0. But what is Peacekeeper, Derek J.? How would you describe the concept to a new listener?
I would say Peacekeeper is an app that allows you to connect with others in your area to respond to emergencies quickly and independently. So you can have it set up so that it notifies the proper authorities, but you could also notify your friends and neighbors so that they respond in the event of a fire, an abduction, an intruder, or some medical emergency.
And they might be able to respond quicker than the government agents could because they're closer to you.
Yeah, and they have a more of an incentive to respond in a way that is in your best interest.
Like they're probably not going to shoot your kid or your dog or something like that.
Yeah.
On the response. So it's a cool idea, and it's an idea that's time has come. They're looking to fundraise through an Indiegogo campaign for Peacekeeper 2.0. They're going to fix the issues with the first version of the software, add some cool new features like GPS positioning and more. You can go to pk.freetalklive.com. That's PK, like Peacekeeper, pk.freetalklive.com. That'll take you right to their Indiegogo fundraiser where you can get signed up and, you know, fund them and get some perks as well. I'm looking forward to the new Peacekeeper 2.0. You can help make it happen and help revolutionize what protection means by contributing now at pk.freetalklive.com. So, Derek J., we kind of started out tonight where you shared a story from a gun rights website,
yeah,
suggesting that this new gay marriage ruling from the Supreme Court has a sort of an unintended consequence in favor of gun rights. The idea being that, well, now, you know, if all states have to recognize a gay marriage license or hand out gay marriage licenses, then therefore all states should also have to recognize. I'm making a very shortened version
of
the argument.
Due process clause. The Supreme Court said that because of the due process clause in the 14th Amendment, states that recognize same-sex marriage, those licenses still carry over. When a couple moves from a place where their marriage is recognized to a place where it isn't, the state's ban on their marriage is invalid. And so that's what the gun rights people are saying is the same case.
Hold on,
for their concealed carry license.
I guess I'm unclear on what happened with the Supreme Court thing. Again, I was at Porkfest all week. I didn't pay close attention.
Yeah, so there are 36...
Just to clarify, are you saying that the states that don't have gay marriage will still not be issuing gay marriage licenses? They'll just have to respect the gay marriage of the people who got a license from a state that does issue it, or that now all 50 states will have to issue gay marriage licenses?
It's my understanding that they'll have to respect the licenses from other states, not that they'll have to issue them per se. I could be incorrect about that, but if from my reading of the due process clause, they're saying, look, if you're from a state like New York, for example, where same-sex marriage is legal, and you move to a state where it isn't, one of the 14 states where it isn't legal, your marriage is still valid.
If you have paid close attention to this and you'd like to clarify, I mean, because that makes sense to me, but then again, it's all a crazy status situation. It would also sort of make sense, too, that this decision would force states to have to accept or to issue these marriage licenses. So share with us what your interpretation is here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I want to read some more from the lefty response to all these claims, that this is somehow going to expand gun rights. Here's a story from MediaMatters.org. They sort of summarized what has happened with the gay marriage thing, and then now they're pointing out that conservative media and the NRA is claiming this is expanding the ability to concealed carry into basically a federal mandate. Reciprocity legislation, they say, has been introduced in both chambers of the Congress, but conservative media and the NRA view this Supreme Court case as an opportunity to argue that the Constitution extends at least some right to reciprocal permit recognition regardless of whether Congress acts. The problem with that argument, however, claims Media Matters, is that the 2008 landmark Supreme Court case, District of Columbia versus Heller, limited the scope of the Second Amendment right to gun possession to people's homes.
Limited the scope? I mean, I'm not so sure. U.S. versus Heller was a pretty landmark decision in that the people of the District of Columbia were... They received a new freedom. They formerly had to have their guns like taken apart, had to be in pieces in your home. You weren't even allowed to own an assembled gun. And now the District of Columbia versus Heller made it clear that, yeah, you can have a gun assembled in your home to defend yourself. So why would it say, yeah, just because they specify in your home to defend yourself, well, why wouldn't you be able to carry it out on the street to defend yourself, especially if you have a permit to do that in one of the 36 states where it's legal?
Well, if the court doesn't address something, that doesn't mean that your interpretation's wrong of what they would say if they were to address it. But if all they said was you only have the right to keep it in your home, that doesn't mean you don't have the right to keep it outside of the home. It just means they didn't say that.
Well, yeah, and it has to be challenged and made more clear.
Despite this, they say, on the June 26th broadcast of the NRA's news show, Cam and Company, host Cam Edwards made the argument that the marriage ruling, quote, might present an additional argument to make at the legal level for extending reciprocity nationwide, saying further, since we're talking about licenses, a lot of gun owners are wondering, okay, could this have an impact on the debate, for instance, over right to carry reciprocity? Unquote. Prominent gun blogger Bob Owens went further, arguing that as a consequence of Obergefell, all other states and the District of Columbia must honor his North Carolina concealed permit or violate his constitutional rights under the 14th and 2nd Amendment.
Yeah.
Breitbart.com's AWR Hawkins made a similar claim, writing, quote, there seems no way to avoid the implication that a state ought to have to recognize a concealed carry license from another state, just as states are now required to recognize same-sex marriage licenses from other states.
You know what, though? I don't want to have to see a person test this, because it means they're going to have to spend tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars in legal fees fighting it. And if it reaches the Supreme Court level again, we're talking millions of dollars just protecting some right that should already be respected. To me, just don't tell the police that you've got a concealed carry, you've got a gun on you. If it's none of their business, if they don't have to know, if you're not being detained, just walk away.
It's probably not going to be easy to fight a legal battle from inside a jail cell in New Jersey either.
Yeah, well, that's a good point. Get out of there if you can. And I mean, but really, if you're concealed carrying, police and nobody else should know that you're carrying. I mean, no one should even know about it. So what does this even matter? I mean, I guess it's going to come down to if police search you. And,
well, right. It happens often enough where, you know, in a place like New York City where they have stop and frisk.
Right. And they have X-ray scanners that they can see through people, see if they're carrying weapons on the sidewalks.
Where the hell's that?
In New York City.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. The
How long has that been around?
The cop cars have like X-ray scanners that they can see if like there's
right out of V for Vendetta.
See if there's
huh?
guns. Yeah.
That's scary. How long has that been going on?
A couple years.
So here's the big claim from Media Matters, Derek. The underlying claimed right that is essential to reciprocity, that is, the carrying of a concealed gun in public, doesn't exist, they say. In 2008, the Supreme Court struck down Washington, D.C.'s ban on keeping a handgun in the home in the case District of Columbia versus Heller. The holding from that case, however, only says that the Second Amendment encompasses the right to own a gun for use in lawful self-defense in the home. So how will this all shake out? I don't know. I'm not saying I take the side of Media Matters here. I just thought it was important to read the other side of the story. What are the lefties saying in response to the gun rights community's claims on this? And what will ultimately the Supreme Court have to say about it? Because like you're saying, Derek J., someone's going to have to challenge this if they really want to find out that it's true. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. Update on Greece coming up.
Hi, my name's Cody, and I want to tell you about Peacekeeper. Peacekeeper is the world's first decentralized peer-to-peer protection system. We are developing a smartphone app that revolutionizes how people protect one another. Peacekeeper is a disruptive alternative to the status quo.
Peacekeeper is a leap forward in protection services, allowing neighbors to respond far more quickly than police and fire services can. And this is a real community builder, too.
Visit peacekeeper.org and join us.
What are you doing?
Looking for the best hotel value in America.
That's easy. It's America's Best Value Inn.
Really?
Sure. They have over 1,000 hotels across North America.
Okay, that's good.
They offer free Wi-Fi, continental breakfast, and HBO at most locations.
That's even better.
And when you join their free value club, you get 15% off, room upgrade, and late checkout when available.
You're right. America's Best Value Inn is the best hotel value in America.
Book a room today at abvi.com.
Done.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, June 29th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.89 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $256. Antiwar.com reports with the June 30th deadline just a day away, there is still no official word on a new extension of the interim P5+1 nuclear agreement, though both U.S. and Iranian officials are confirming that negotiators are planning to remain in Vienna beyond the deadline to continue the talks. It's not unusual for this to happen in the lead-up to a deadline, as officials often try to play hardball at the last minute and claim the deadline this time is firm, though each time they eventually all concede that the talks are just too complicated to wrap up in time, and that more time is needed. A six-month extension seems the most likely result, as it would push the talks toward the end of the year, giving more time for talks. As with past extensions, this is sure to spawn a new round of condemnation from congressional hawks and foreign factions opposed to the nuclear talks, notably Israel. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports the Falcon 9 reusable rocket from SpaceX on Sunday suffered its third failed fiery attempt to launch for outer space and return to land on a drone ship. NASA held a joint press conference with SpaceX representatives about the rocket's failure. SpaceX, owned by Elon Musk, launched the Falcon 9 at 10:21 a.m. on Sunday. The main objective of the mission was to deliver a SpaceX Dragon capsule to the International Space Station as part of a $1.6 billion contract with NASA. SpaceX President and Chief Operating Officer Gwynn Shotwell said, "Up until 139 seconds into the flight, we experienced an anomaly which led to a failure of the mission. We are obviously collecting data." Shotwell added that there were signs of pressurization and that no safety issues were reported. William H. Gerstenmaier, Associate Administrator for Human Exploration and Operations at NASA, said that it was a tough day. Supplies at the International Space Station are adequate, but there was a significant loss of research equipment, including a spacesuit. Gerstenmaier added that the crew is not in danger.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton said on Sunday that county clerks in Texas who object to same-sex marriage can refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples, despite last week's landmark U.S. Supreme Court ruling requiring states to allow same-sex marriage. The nation's top court said on Friday that the U.S. Constitution provides same-sex couples the right to marriage. Paxton said in a statement that hundreds of public officials in Texas were seeking guidance on how to implement what he called a lawless and flawed decision by an activist court. The state's attorney general said that while the Supreme Court justices had fabricated a new constitutional right, they did not diminish, overrule, or call into question the First Amendment right to free exercise of religion. Paxton wrote, "County clerks and their employees retain religious freedoms that may allow accommodation of their religious objection to issuing same-sex marriage licenses," adding that the strength of any such claim would depend on the facts of each case. He noted that officials who refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples could expect to be sued, but he said they would have ample legal support. Last week's 5-4 ruling by the Supreme Court was the culmination of a long legal fight by gay rights advocates. It unleashed a torrent of emotions both for and against the decision. The ruling was the High Court's most important expansion of marriage rights in the United States since the landmark 1967 ruling in the case of Loving v. Virginia, which struck down state laws barring interracial marriage. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Thomas the Tank Engine says he's a little uneasy with his broad autistic following, and a couple has a nest egg of debt to make sure they've got some money to owe down the road. This is the Onion Week in Review. Local video editor James Korf told reporters Wednesday that despite having said goodbye over 10 minutes ago, his friend, Michael Woodward, still remained active on GChat and had shown no signs of leaving.
If it were yellow, it would mean that he hasn't been on the computer for a little while, or if it was red, it would mean he doesn't want to talk, but it's green. I can tell. I can see it right there.
Korf later said that he felt briefly relieved when Woodward's chat logo turned orange, but was once again dejected when it became green within seconds. And in this week's op-ed pages, a high school guidance counselor laments the fact that no one in his entire damn school has been molested. In other news, a bed bug feels bad for an area man, but a bug's gotta eat. A development exec wants to see what, where, and how that would look, live, and play out. And a man at the gym is just watching TV. For more, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is the Onion News Network.
Back now with more Free Talk Live, launching into the second hour of the program. Coming up, an update on Greece. Last night, we had talked about how there was a run on the ATMs over the weekend because banks are usually closed on weekends. People were emptying out cash, 500 out of 7,000 ATMs in Greece had been completely emptied out as of Saturday.
Whoops.
Then on Sunday, they called for a bank closure, a bank holiday, as it is called.
Whee! It's a holiday!
For today.
You can't get your money!
Right. And, well, of course, the banks have access to it, but you can't. And, of course, a bank holiday gives all the bankers time to get their money out before
Why don't they call it a banker's party? I mean, why do they call it a holiday? Like, are they fooling anyone?
I think they might be fooling someone. There's got to be somebody out there who's fooled by this. But
oh, it's okay. It's just a holiday.
Who could be against a holiday? You don't want these bankers to not have a day off, do you? Well, anyway, we'll talk about what's going on there because it's getting worse in Greece. And as you thought it might, it is. We'll tell you what's happening. On the way here, 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. It's Ian and Derek J in the studio. Let's go to Dave. He is on the road in Massachusetts. Dave, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how are you guys doing? Thanks a lot for having me on.
Sure, Dave. Go ahead.
I wanted to chime in a little bit on this little controversy over the Confederate flag here this weekend at Porkfest.
What controversy?
I just saw a few posts flying by. I was pretty interested in reading those. But moreover, and what's most shocking in this, I think initially a lot of us saw the beating of the drums through the media these last few weeks. Obviously, something horrible happened. Someone adopted this symbol as their rally flag. And, of course, all the gun grabbers are going to take full advantage of this. And what happened at Porkfest is that I was having just a great time meeting people throughout the weekend, and I go down for the big class picture at the end.
Yeah.
And I'll be darned if one of the staff didn't come up to me and say that my Confederate flag, there were certain people were a little sensitive to it and did not want Porkfest to be viewed as a racist gathering.
Hmm.
And it just blew my socks off. This is, in my head, is the antithesis of what this event is supposed to stand for. Really blew me over. And what I told him was, I was going to leave the scene without incident, just out of respect for the event. I've been there for year after year. But I was going to do so in protest. And I told him more specifically that the real shame in this is it's a lost opportunity to educate. And that's what I thought was supposed to be going on up there. You know, I really liked the event. I got to meet some great people from all over the place over the years. But these last couple of years have really kind of taken me aback a little bit. And to be banned from the picture is bad enough. You know, their new security efforts up there, I think, leave a little bit to be desired, as many of the locals were stealing the
map. Were you banned from the picture, Dave?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because you wanted to fly the flag?
Yeah. I was flying the Confederate flag, and I was dragging the UN flag in the dirt, too.
Do you think I should be able to fly the white nationalist flag in the Porkfest official picture?
You know, I think anyone who wants... If we're truly going to have free speech, it's not the popular speech that needs to be protected.
Well, I don't support having that kind of free speech personally, sir. I mean, I'll have to say I would not want to associate with anyone who supports waving a white nationalist flag. I can understand where you're coming from, that you don't believe that the Confederate flag stands for racism, but a lot of people do, and so I can understand the hesitancy of the Porkfest organizers to restrict that from appearing there. And the fact that you would feel comfortable with having someone waving a white nationalist flag gives me pause, sir.
I didn't say comfortable. I didn't say comfortable. I never said that. But then if to take a right from someone else, you're taking a right.
It's not
from
your right. It's private property. So, you know, on private property, you don't have a right to say everything you want to say. Like, for instance, right now, you're on the airwaves on Free Talk Live, and this is a private property. We allow generally anyone to talk about anything they want, but if you use the F word, then I'm going to have to hit the dump button and get rid of your phone call. You know, that's just one of the rules here on this private property. While I support freedom of speech, that doesn't mean I necessarily have to support everything that everyone is saying with their freedom of speech, nor do I have to associate with people who would use their speech in certain ways that many people would find very, very offensive.
Yeah, I kind of look at it this way, Dave. Like, I'm not offended by the Confederate flag. To me,
it
represents an attempt by the states in the past to reclaim their sovereignty. And I don't see it as having racist roots, although I know a lot of people would disagree. But I would have a problem with someone flying a white nationalist flag in front of me in some picture, because it would suggest to the viewer that I am a white nationalist, and I'm not, you know, and I don't want to present that image.
It certainly suggests that you weren't willing to do anything about it, right?
Right,
like,
right.
You didn't say anything.
Yeah, like here I am smiling and then looking like a racist. And to a lot of people who look at the Confederate flag, I get how you and I see it differently. But there's going to be someone who looks at that and says, oh, my goodness, look at all of these racists. What? I don't want to be a part of that group. And, you know, so the symbol has the meaning of racism, yeah, whether we want to attribute it or not.
Well, you know, but we got to stop letting the government and other interests steal the vocabulary and steal the meaning and redefine things.
Well, but
so how do you do it?
I would give you. Here's an example. Let's say that some lunatic comes up and adopts the PETA logo and puts on his flag as a rally cry and comes up and sets me on fire because I'm wearing leather boots. Mm-hmm. You know, would I go after PETA for such a thing? Did they condone that? Did they instruct him to do that? PETA does some very odd things, but I don't think they condone setting people on fire.
Right.
Now, should you know, Porkfest, this is the Porkfest porcupine, got adopted by some lunatic. I mean, when are we going to stop letting them steal the vocabulary?
Well, I get where you're coming from, but there's a difference between some lunatic adopting your symbol and putting it up on his crazy website that nobody goes to, and decades upon decades upon decades of mass confusion and misinformation surrounding a symbol. Right. So what you're saying isn't exactly comparing apples to apples here. I mean, the Confederate flag has a lot of baggage attached to it. The porcupine logo doesn't have that baggage attached to it, and one lunatic appropriating it for their website or their movement that no one really pays any attention to is a relatively irrelevant thing. But the Confederate flag, trying to save the Confederate flag, is just as, I think, futile as trying to save the word anarchy. I mean, there's a bunch of people in the liberty movement who love to plaster themselves with the word anarchist while giving some long explanation for, oh, wait, I'm not an anarchist like those anarchists over there, those ones setting buildings on fire and, you know, destroying private property. I'm the anarchist that supports private property. I'm the anarchist that this and that. So they have all this explaining to do about their, you know, the word that they've applied for themselves. Whereas if you call yourself a voluntarist, you don't have to deconstruct the word anarchism and explain to people why your anarchy is the proper anarchy. You can just explain that as a voluntarist, you support human interaction being consensual. End of conversation. So, I mean, you know, get a new flag. Don't try to save this old flag.
Make a flag. What about a New Hampshire secession flag?
I mean, what about the due diligence that was in place when that flag was formed? I mean, every color, every symbol, every star means something. And not one
It doesn't mean anything to anyone remote. These days. You know, I don't know what the stars stand for. I would have to go and read a Wikipedia article about the Confederate flag. And I was born in the South, right? I support the idea of secession. I'm all in favor of secession. But that doesn't mean I'm going to start waving the Confederate flag out of my window or attach it to the back of my pickup truck.
I'm not even out there. My message wasn't to go out there and advocate that we secede from the nation. It really is...
Then why? Why wave the Confederate flag? What's the point?
To educate.
About what?
You know, you get out there. I walk amongst people. I work in a town hall where people walk around like zombies.
If you're not educating about secession, about what are you educating?
Really, it's about the refusal to let that be demonized and redefined for a political end. And
but
for
why?
Me, more personally to me, is my willingness to resist.
But you have no reason. I mean, just because you like the symbol? I mean, what's the reason for flying the flag?
If it's not to support secession,
hang on, Dave. I'll bring you back. I'd like you to answer the question because I'm very curious. If you don't support secession, why are you flying the Confederate flag? Unless you're a racist. That's not what you are, right?
Discover how deep your American roots go for free this 4th of July weekend. Go to TryAncestry.com to get free access through July 5th. Visit TryAncestry.com anytime this Wednesday through Sunday, and you'll have free access to our collection of records from the original 13 colonies and with a new visual story experience. Celebrate this 4th of July and take advantage of this free access weekend. Visit TryAncestry.com. That's TryAncestry.com. TryAncestry.com.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
If you're worried about your health and you're tired of the nasty side effects of harsh drugs or antibiotics, then look no further. Supernatural Silver is the answer. Supernatural Silver is a powerful immune system enhancer that can be used every day to help keep you healthy and well with none of those nasty side effects. It's extremely safe for use internally as well as topically. And Supernatural Silver is hundreds of times more effective than colloidal or ionic silver. It is perfect for use in the sinuses, eyes, ears, and on any wound or skin issue. Supernatural Silver is also extremely effective when taken orally and can help fight off bacteria, viruses, and mold that may be overwhelming your immune system. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com. SupernaturalSilver.com and use the promo code Silver2015 for 30% off of your entire order and give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance with Supernatural Silver.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, talking about the Confederate flag. This is apparently, Derek J., something else that has been in the news. While you and I were having a blast for a week at Porkfest, there's all kinds of news about somebody taking down the Confederate flag in, what was it, South Carolina or something like
Why'd they take it down?
That's about all I know, Derek. Honestly, I haven't been following the news. I have completely disconnected for a week while I was at the Porcupine Freedom Festival. But all of a sudden, the Confederate flag's in the news again, and people are talking about it. And
why? I guess people care about these flags so much. The flag burnings, the flag raising. Oh, you have to dispose of a flag properly. You have to fold it up. All of this worry about the flags.
Just a thing.
Who cares?
Yeah.
Didn't the Dukes of Hazzard used to wear the Confederate flag on like bikinis and stuff?
It was on their car, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I believe it was. So, look, I got no problem if you want to wave a Confederate flag from your home or your car or whatever. It's your life. It's your thing. I support secession, but I'm not going to wave the Confederate flag. I mean, by all means, the South should rise again.
It's confusing. It's too confusing. This guy, Dave, says that, you know, he flies the flag to educate. But the flag is not a book.
No.
It doesn't educate. Okay? It's a symbol. And so it stands for something, and in people's minds, it stands for different things. So at that, it's a very bad symbol. It's
right. The only way you could educate someone with it is if someone took the time to ask you, hey, why are you flying that flag? And that's what I just asked Dave a moment ago before we went to break, and I wanted to hold on to him to get his answer here in a moment, why this is so important to him, because he said it wasn't about secession for him. So if it's not about secession, then what is it about?
Yeah, I'd like to know.
So we'll get into that. If you're online, whether it's your cell phone, your laptop, your work computer, if you're online at all, there's a good chance somebody is monitoring what you're doing. Maybe it's your internet service provider who's logging every website you visit, every search term you enter, keeping those logs for several years in some cases. Perhaps it's a criminal sniffing out your Wi-Fi packets while you're sitting there tapping away at your favorite coffee shop. You know, all of these things are possible unless you encrypt your internet connection. Then it makes it near to very impossible to actually monitor anything you're doing online when you have ProXPN. That's what ProXPN does. It's a global virtual private network that encrypts your data that you're sending and receiving online. And that means that your ISP will no longer know what you're doing. And those criminals sniffing your Wi-Fi packets will be foiled. So go and get started over at proxpn.com/FTL. You can download their software for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux. Get started for free over at proxpn.com/FTL. When you're ready to upgrade, however, to their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can access, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. Plus, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. You can do that for 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy their annual account with code FTL50. It breaks the price down to about $5 a month, and that is good for the lifetime of your account. So when you're ready to continue on for year number two, you'll get the same awesome deal from proxpn.com/FTL. Don't forget to use promo code FTL50. There's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. It's an awesome level of privacy protection for a very small price. proxpn.com/FTL, promo code FTL50. As we go back to Dave, he is on the road heading toward Massachusetts, leaving the Porcupine Freedom Festival. Dave, you were disappointed being asked to not participate in the large group photo that is taken every year at Porkfest this year because you were intending to fly a Confederate flag. There were some, I think, legitimate concerns that people looking at the photo might get the wrong idea. They might jump to a conclusion that because the Confederate flag was in the photo, that meant that this was a group of people who are racist. And obviously that's not the case. I mean, there were black people at Porkfest, probably in that very picture would be my guess. But nonetheless, I could see why the organizers were concerned with that. I went on to ask you the question of why you support the flag so much. Why is it so important to you to save this old symbol? What is it about it?
Well, I think just before we went to break, what I said was a little bit misapplied. In that, you know, I'm not saying that I do not believe in secession, as I do too. I don't think we should go along just because we're told to. States should have the right. Their governors should have control of their individual states and not be forced to do really much of anything by the federal government and to secede if necessary.
But that's not why you fly the flag, the Confederate flag.
This year specifically, because of what's going on in the press right now, what we're seeing right now, if and this is where I'm a little bit surprised that you guys might not identify to the danger that you're seeing here. If you just give up, you throw in the white flag and say, you know, this flag, this state flag has been tarnished so badly and called racist for so long. Let them have it. Let's give up.
Mm-hmm.
What is to stop them from doing that to anything?
They do. What about
words? I apply this to the Free State Project.
But words and meanings change over time.
Yeah, these things don't happen overnight. I mean, the Confederate flag has been associated with racism for decades. This isn't something that somebody just decided, oh, let's change what this thing means to people. You know, all of a sudden...
You're already telling us liberty people are extremists and we're showing up on watch lists. I'm a two-time Ron Paul delegate to the convention, and I can tell you, this country is in a lot of trouble. And if you keep giving up on everything... And you know, I've never been outside of the boring state of Massachusetts in my whole pathetic life. I'm not a Southerner. But I'll tell you what, I'll fight for their symbol.
It doesn't make any sense. It's not their symbol.
No one's asking you to.
No one, it's not their symbol. It's
a state flag is being demonized as a racist symbol, and it is not. It is a propaganda.
But who cares? I mean, why is it so important to you?
We all should.
No, we all should not, and we all never will. You can't get everybody to agree on one thing, but it's still not clear to me why you've taken this, you know, this mantle up. Why is this something that you're willing to spend your time, your precious time? You only have so much time every single day that you can spend on things, and you've decided to tote this ancient old flag that is super confusing to people as far as what it actually means, as though, you know, you're somehow going to single-handedly repair its reputation.
Well, I got to tell you, out of the 100 or so people that approached me to take pictures and ask questions, I had an opportunity to explain that the red and that flag was for the blood of the soldiers that secured their freedom and liberty, that the stars were for the individual colonies, and that cross, that was their X, that was their vote against a top-heavy statist type of situation and individual states' rights. the symbols and everything were carefully discussed and formed to make a very specific statement. And it's not a symbol of racism.
And it's been lost to the sands of time. Whatever that statement was has been long gone. And so why you're spending your precious man hours on this project, I don't understand it. Yeah. But if that's your that's your thing, man.
Yeah, I was multitasking. I was on vacation at the same time. But on the other end, although I had the Confederate flag flying on a birch rod, I also had the UN flag dragging in the dirt.
Thanks for the call tonight, Dave. I appreciate hearing from you. I don't know. I don't get it.
So
what
if everyone understood the Confederate flag the way Dave does? Then what?
So what? Yeah, are we going to secede tomorrow? No, probably not. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. You know, I've got limited time. I want to spend time helping people understand the ideas of liberty. And waving around the Confederate flag is not going to be the most efficient means of doing that. But what do you think? You can share your thoughts. Free Talk Live.
Want to listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programs without a radio signal or internet? Just call 605-562-4213. Get instant access to all GCN live feeds right on your phone, anywhere you want, anytime you want. 605-562-4213. It's our way of ensuring everyone has the opportunity to enjoy GCN. 605-562-4213. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Hi, this is Larry Smith. Sometimes bad things happen to good people. When the cleaners ruined some special clothing, all they could do was show us a sign that said they weren't responsible. But when they got the letter from one of our Legal Shield attorneys, he promptly gave us a check for $1,152. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
How many lawyers does it take to change a light bulb? None. They'd rather keep their clients in the dark. There are too many lawyer jokes to count. However, there are some lawyers with more noble intentions. At the Institute for Justice, we bring the light to our clients. We are a nonprofit public interest law firm with clear values and principles. At IJ, we fight for those whose most basic rights are denied by the government. Visit our website today at ij.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
America is at a crossroads on many issues, leading many to ask, is it time for the president to blow the silver horn left behind by the founding fathers in case the country ever needed them? Of course, the horn, which has been sitting in the Oval Office since 1817, has never been used by a commander-in-chief, but many Americans think now might be the time to summon our forefathers. Which founding fathers would come back?
All of them. Look, when you have a bug problem, you call the exterminator. When you have an America problem, you call the founding fathers. They know what to do.
We have to keep in mind the Founding Fathers left us with a warning. If you blow the horn with less than pure intentions, it will turn to tin and can never be used.
But a president has to take risks, have the courage to admit that his administration is not all-knowing and blow that magic silver horn to summon someone who is.
Yes, but what if we become too reliant on them and they disappear after the next new moon, as was written? Yeah.
This is the Onion News Network.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, join us on the radio waves to bring up whatever you would like to discuss with us and our audience. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. Now that we're back in our Keene, New Hampshire studios from a week in the woods, we finally have Skype available again. You can call us on Skype at username lrn.fm. You have to add Free Talk Live as your friend first, so add username lrn.fm. We will approve it, and then once that's done, it'll be easy for you to call us from that point forward via Skype. Let's continue here with your calls and thoughts. Ryan is listening in Illinois. Ryan, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello there.
Hey, guys. I had an idea for the Burning Man people and how to deal with the rock star bureaucrats.
Yeah. Okay, for our listeners who don't know what you're referring to, there was an article we talked about last night. The folks who are trying to put together the Burning Man Festival for, I don't know, like its 28th or 29th year this year are running into more difficulty than ever before with the Bureau of Land Management demanding that they build a, in addition to $4 million in fees, $4 million just to actually have the spot in the Black Rock Desert, which nothing exists out there, but you know they're charging $4 million to rent that space. In addition, they now want a $1 million VIP compound complete with flushing toilets, which are unheard of on
in the desert.
On the playa in Black Rock City.
Okay.
Flushing toilets and all manner of ridiculous demands about all kinds of fancy foods and sinks and washers and dryers and just kind of just a crazy, super kind of rich area for these government agents to hang out in. The VIPs, if you will. Anyway, that was what the story was. Go ahead, Ryan.
I figured, you know, maybe they could follow all of their rules, about, you know, get all the stuff on their food list and just build their mansion for them, but build it out of glass to promote government transparency and have a little greenhouse in the desert there. And you could go every day and you could put fresh Choco Tacos down and have them melt in the greenhouse. And then when they don't like it and they say, well, you did it, but, you know, this is unacceptable, you could say, oh, yeah, we'll have a committee. We'll look into that. We'll do our own investigation and, you know, come up with rules to try and make it better next year. And maybe, you know, maybe they'll have to have somebody resign over it, too.
It's a cute idea, but I suspect the construction, given the detail that is paid to the types of food that are to be offered in this contract. You mentioned the Choco Taco. That was one of the requirements. Given the attention to detail paid with that, I suspect there will be some level of attention to detail paid as far as the construction materials and how the VIP palace will be constructed. Unfortunately, the Bureau of Land Management holds the cards on this one. You know, they have they have the land. And they know that Burning Man organizers want that spot, and that's why they've raised the price.
Why does it have to be that spot? Can't they go somewhere
else? It should go to private property is what it should do, but they've had this spot for two decades now, and they want to continue there for obvious reasons, but now it's getting ridiculously costly. It was in 2011, I think it was $800,000. 2012, it went to $1.4 million. 2013, it went to $2.9 million. 2014, it went to $4 million. Now it's $4 million plus $1 million VIP facility for government agents.
Look, some people may look at this as like, hey, well, we've been there so long and we deserve to be there, but... and then it's wrong to back down if government agents or a mafia whoever says, nice land you got here. It'd be a shame if something were to happen to it and we're going to charge you $1 million or $4 million to use it. Just go somewhere else. Well is the best revenge. Why don't you just move on? It's not like you're defeated or you can still have your event and make it a success. Just move to a different place. I'm sorry, the bureaucrats won this one.
I know you can buy right now in New Hampshire, which isn't the arid desert, You can buy forest land in New Hampshire. There's 376 acres of it for sale right now, just out on the border of Keene and a couple of other towns here in this area. Last time I looked, it was getting close to $1 million.
So you could...
You could take
a lot of money left over.
$4 million that you're going to give. Like, over the last 5 years, these guys have given several million dollars, like $10-plus million dollars,
yeah,
to the Bureau of Land Management just so they can throw this party. They could take $4 million. They could take half that and probably buy a plot of land that would be bigger than Black Rock City could ever possibly grow to encompass.
Yeah. Yep.
So this is just so insane that they're going to continue to try to negotiate with the BLM. Ryan, anything else you want to add to the discussion?
Yeah, I just thought it'd be fun to make it uncomfortable for them, and maybe you could accidentally make the glass with a convex shape and kind of do what kids with a magnifying glass do to ants in the desert there.
Burn them up. Thanks for the call, Ryan. I appreciate it. Yeah, it would be interesting to see how the burners responded to this sort of palace, this palatial VIP structure being built on this sort of this place that is known for being very back to its roots kind of mentality. I don't know how to best describe it. I've never been there.
Government just ruins everything. I mean,
self-sufficient.
Why do they have to get involved in this in the first place? When they
asked the government for permission to be there. So it was the folks from Burning Man that went to the government.
That's a real mistake.
Right.
I mean, I hope they've learned from this. Like, oh, hey, maybe
apparently
next time
they
we
haven't
shouldn't
yet.
Ask.
I mean, it's now 20-something years where they've been paying the government some sort of amount. Only in the last 5 years it's been getting into the point of ridiculousness. But, you know, apparently they haven't learned yet. Now, they're balking at the demands, the Burning Man organizers.
I can't believe what they're making us do.
Right.
It's like, well, why did you ask in the first place? Yeah, it's so much better to ask forgiveness than permission, especially with these government bureaucrats. The answer is always going to be no, or pay us more money.
Of course it is. And to double it year after year? I mean, this is an adding insult to injury.
They've really got some nerve charging this money to the people. Like, first of all, you only get to sell or rent land to people if you justly acquired that property.
Sure.
And we know, everybody knows that the government didn't justly acquire the property that it owns, that it just stole it or it took it by force. So who could possibly think it's legitimate to pay rent to an organization of people who never even own the land?
It's not like you're paying for any kind of services. I mean, the Bureau of Land Management is making the claim that we need to have our bureaucrats out there for this. Well, for what? What are you going to do?
Shake people down as they enter, make sure they don't have any fun drugs with them.
Well, I don't know if BLM does that. That would be the police. But
okay.
The Bureau of Land Management in this case, they're not providing cleanup services. It's not like Burning Man is paying $4 million and they're getting somebody to go and like clean the area up.
They pay $4 million and then they get to have their event.
They get to clean it up too. Like,
oh boy,
they get to put the event together. They get to run the event. The Burning Man people clean it up.
They sound like a bunch of suckers. I'm sorry, but how much are people paying for these Burning Man tickets?
Too much. I remember a few years ago, and this was before the price went insane for just the rental that Burning Man's paying. It was $370 just for one ticket.
Isn't this the same place that like bans money?
That's correct.
Can't, okay, fine. These people can live in the woods and be stupid together. You know, they're willing to pay millions of dollars to the government for
sad nothing,
and then they ban money because they're so, principled.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. They're confused and stupid.
Super confused. I don't know if they're stupid, but they're...
No, they're stupid. I'm sorry. If you're going to pay $4 million for land that you could go buy somewhere else where it would be more comfortable, and you just tell people, hey, it's happening here instead of there.
Yeah. I mean, it just doesn't make sense. There are so many people involved in the Burning Man community. We're talking about a city that forms of nearly 70,000 people. Every one of those 70,000 people knows another 1,000 people. Somebody knows somebody who's got some land in Nevada who would be either willing to rent it temporarily or sell several acres of it so they can throw this party every year without having to spend millions of dollars on nothing.
Yeah, and you wouldn't have to worry as much if you have private security.
You could throw
the
cops
police.
The hell out.
Yeah.
That's one of the other great points, Derek J., because the cops have been getting worse and worse. If you talk to people from Burning Man, there's a greater police presence year after year, and it becomes way less fun to be tripping with a bunch of cops around. That's just... I'm just going to speculate on that. I don't think I would like to be tripping.
I don't want to see blue lights
around a bunch of cops, especially cops that are making arrests of my fellow burners, if I were one, which I'm not. But I am still fascinated by the festival. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
It is the year 91001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. ZOG.ninja. Code FTL.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Whether you want to talk about Greece or, let's see, we also discussed the Porcupine Freedom Festival, the gay marriage Supreme Court decision, and whether or not that's going to have an effect on gun rights. The Confederate flag came up tonight as well. You can join us here toll-free. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Right now, Derek J., you are tooling around over on Amazon looking to make a purchase. I just added something to my Amazon wish list earlier today. I've been actually meaning to get a new router for the studio here, and cool. I was kind of playing around because I knew Porkfest was coming up, and I don't want to order things from through Purse while I'm not at home because when you order something through Purse and the product gets delivered, usually the person who ordered it for you is waiting urgently for you.
Yeah,
to receive
I didn't
it.
Know that. Whoops.
Yeah, so
I got home and sent through the escrow.
Right. So what happens with Purse is you can get up to 25% off or more on your Amazon purchases. And the way you do it is you use Bitcoin to make the purchase. And so essentially somebody is buying your Bitcoin. They're paying for the Amazon product at full price and essentially paying a premium to purchase your Bitcoin. Mm-hmm. So the person who's buying the Bitcoin, they want to get their Bitcoin. And so they sometimes they're a little impatient. They'll send you a message maybe now and then saying, hey, has the product arrived? Go ahead and release the funds. And so I always want to make sure I'm going to be around if I'm doing this. So I added a router to my wish list on Amazon, went over to purse.freetalklive.com, and I added my wish list in there, and it sucks all the items out and puts them into Purse and then gives you a little slider, and it asks you, what percentage discount do you want? And I decided I wanted this thing fairly quickly, so I set it at 20%.
Okay.
It was filled within an hour and a half.
Wow.
Meaning someone decided to make that purchase for me on Amazon, that router, specific router that I wanted, within 90 minutes of me saying I want this thing at 20% off. You can get 25% off or more or up to 25%, whatever amount you want, basically, off on from Amazon. Now, the larger the percentage, the longer you're going to have to wait. So the same router, I set at 50% while I was at Porkfest because I figured no one was going to bite at 50%. And indeed, no one did bite at 50%. So again, as soon as I set it to 20%, bam, it sold. And so that's how awesome Purse is. You can go to purse.freetalklive.com. When you sign up through that link, Free Talk Live will get a very small percentage of each transaction that you do at Purse. And once you go through purse.freetalklive.com and sign up for an account, you can go through their regular URL from that point forward. So you don't have to keep going through purse.freetalklive.com. That's just a sign up and get some amazing deals on the stuff you're going to buy anyway. When you pay with Bitcoin, you can get a bunch of money off. Purse.freetalklive.com. It works. I love it. Huge fan of the Purse system. And you've started using it, right, Derek J?
Yes, I use it all the time now.
Isn't it great?
Yeah, I'm addicted.
So anyway, let's continue here. We were talking, or I guess we were going to talk about Greece. We never really got into the story. I think that was because we had that call about the Confederate flag. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Is there anything more to say about the Confederate? I don't think there's much more to say.
Well, one thing that I learned recently is that the Confederate flag, as most people know it, is not the Confederate flag that was flown during the Civil War. I just recently read, you know, the one that most people know is the cross, the one that Dave, the caller, was describing, never actually flew in the Civil War, people think it did. The stars
just goes to show people don't know much about the Confederate flag.
Yeah,
right?
Even those who are seeking to educate others, as Dave seemed to be doing. So anyway,
let's talk about the Greek flag in this case. The Washington Post is giving us an update on what's happening there. Today was supposed to be a bank holiday in Greece, which, of course, was previous to a major deadline that Greece had was about to hit, I think, tomorrow. And it's technically tomorrow in Greece right now. This deadline about the money that they've been loaned, this bailout money that they've been given by 19 countries, I think mostly from the Eurozone. But here's a story from Washington Post. Greek leaders planned to shutter their banks for 6 business days starting Monday. So it was going to be one day. Yesterday they said, oh, we're going to close our banks on Monday. And now Monday comes and they're saying, we're going to close the banks all week long. 6 business
days.
That'll
solve the problem.
Yeah. Which means 6 business days, so that's 5 days for the week, and then Monday
so
next
week.
So
what is their hope, that people just forget they need money? Like, oh, hey, honey, like, go to the bank on Monday. Oh, it's closed. Oh, okay, yeah, it's going to be closed all week. Like, oh, we don't need money. Yeah, just forget about that.
Well,
you know, we don't need to go grocery shopping or do any of the important things we need to do with money.
They're just trying to figure out what the hell they're going to do next, I think.
I'm just wondering, do the ATM cards work at the grocery store, or is it just that the ATMs themselves are running out of cash? Is is it a cash shortage problem?
It's the cash that's running out at the ATMs.
Okay,
yeah.
But it's not like that.
The electronic electronic money system, I don't think has been shut down. If that's what you're asking,
right?
So let's see. So oh, and further, they're imposing strict limits on ATM withdrawals now. So previously, people were cashing out as much as they possibly could. Now they're going to make it even more difficult to use the ATM to get your money out.
And some people are saying that they have limits on their digital transfers prior to this happening. They already had limits in Greece on digital transfers of cash.
Now they're even more limited, however. The story goes on. Sunday's decision to declare a bank holiday was a signal that Greece's five-year battle to stay in the shared euro currency may swiftly be coming to an end, as leaders elsewhere urged steps to find a way to avoid that. Panicked citizens tried to pull their money from their accounts while they still could. ATMs in Athens were running out of money and tensions were running high as Greeks stood in line for hours to scrape together cash for basic supplies. Lines mounted at gas stations as worried residents topped off their tanks for what could be a protracted period of time in a cashless nation. Quote, the decision to prolong financial aid to Greece is offensive, and it's a disgrace for Europe in general, says Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras in a brief Sunday evening address across Greek television networks. He said he was seeking an extended and enlarged bailout from European lenders that would carry the country past Tuesday when it'll otherwise face default. There were signs that their creditors were leaving the door open to negotiations, blah, 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 blah. That's basically a retread of what we shared last night. So basically here's the limit on the ATM withdrawal. So
what is it?
Early Monday, the government published the decision to close the banks until after the referendum. This is a referendum they're going to be holding on July 5th, so in about a week.
So the informed Greek people can make their wise decision collectively.
Yeah, so the referendum will be asking Greeks whether they would accede to the austerity demands of the nation's creditors. Greek leaders have urged their citizens to vote no. So just to clarify, the creditors want their $1 billion back. They want their $1.6 billion or whatever it is that the amount is that they have to pay by Tuesday. And they would like their money, and they would like payments as soon as possible. The guy who's running the country is saying, I will not be a part of this. This is not for Greece. We need a bigger bailout, and we need it now. We can't be cutting back our size of government. The Greek people will not stand for this. And so they're going to have a referendum where the Greek people will register whether or not they're willing to go through these austerity measures, these
like
cutbacks.
Idiocracy,
basically.
Like, do you like money? I like money. These people, who's going to vote themselves less money? They're like, oh, right. Okay, go to the polls, and, you know, if you vote, what is it? It's yes if you want austerity measures, and no that if you don't want austerity
measures.
That's
correct.
So, okay, who's going to go in and vote for fiscal responsibility? Really?
The people
Has that
are likely
ever
not
happened?
Going to do that, yeah. And so if they don't vote for fiscal responsibility, then the creditors...
Let's be responsible!
The creditors will consider that Greece has defaulted on its loans and basically cut them out of the euro.
Yeah.
That's the idea.
This is... there are no chance for responsibility. It's let's vote ourselves other people's money. Let's kick the can down the road a little bit longer. And who's going to be the next lender of last resort for them, if not the IMF?
They're going to have to start printing their own money.
Right.
That's what it's likely going to do, or adopt some other currency.
They used to do. So I guess they'll have the euro plus what was the drachma or whatever.
I don't know what the Greek currency was.
Yeah.
But now it's a $66 daily limit on an ATM withdrawal.
That's all you need, right? You don't need any more than 66 bucks out of the ATM.
Greeks can continue to pay their bills online, but they cannot move their money abroad.
And that sounds like it's actually a $60 limit, because I don't know any ATMs that spit out ones.
Yeah, good point. That's right. Well, maybe it's $66 converted from Greek money or converted from euros or something. Yeah. A Greek economic official also said the Greek stock market would remain closed Monday. Most Asian markets were sharply lower on the news, and the euro plunged more than 1% against the dollar. But guess what's going up? Bitcoin.
Oh, how about that?
Yeah.
Let me check on Bitcoin.
Last time I looked, it was getting close to $260.
Wow. It's been climbing all day today.
What's it at right now?
158.
Wait,
or excuse me, 258. Yeah, sorry. I was just looking at the last couple of digits.
Yeah, it's been a slow climb.
258.
It's been a slow climb. And in fact, I touched on the interest in Greece about Bitcoin last night. There's a more detailed story about the explosion of Greek interest in Bitcoin. All of a sudden, Bitcoin is very viable in Greece. We will give you more information. You can share your thoughts coming up here. Plus, a mom has been charged for allowing her 7-year-old to play in the park across the street. This is not the same story that we told you about a few weeks ago. It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, my name's Cody, and I want to tell you about Peacekeeper. Peacekeeper is the world's first decentralized peer-to-peer protection system. We are developing a smartphone app that revolutionizes how people protect one another. Peacekeeper is a disruptive alternative to the status quo.
Peacekeeper is a leap forward in protection services, allowing neighbors to respond far more quickly than police and fire services can. And this is a real community builder, too.
Visit peacekeeper.org and join us.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, June 29th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.89 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $256. Antiwar.com reports with the June 30th deadline just a day away, there is still no official word on a new extension of the interim P5+1 nuclear agreement, though both U.S. and Iranian officials are confirming that negotiators are planning to remain in Vienna beyond the deadline to continue the talks. It's not unusual for this to happen in the lead up to a deadline, as officials often try to play hardball at the last minute and claim the deadline this time is firm, though each time they eventually all concede that the talks are just too complicated to wrap up in time, and that more time is needed. A 6-month extension seems the most likely result, as it would push the talks toward the end of the year, giving more time for talks. As with past extensions, this is sure to spawn a new round of condemnation from congressional hawks and foreign factions opposed to the nuclear talks, notably Israel. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports the Falcon 9 reusable rocket from SpaceX on Sunday suffered its third failed fiery attempt to launch for outer space and return to land on a drone ship. NASA held a joint press conference with SpaceX representatives about the rocket's failure. SpaceX, owned by Elon Musk, launched the Falcon 9 at 10:21 a.m. on Sunday. The main objective of the mission was to deliver a SpaceX Dragon capsule to the International Space Station as part of a $1.6 billion contract with NASA. SpaceX President and Chief Operating Officer Gwynne Shotwell said, up until 139 seconds into the flight, we experienced an anomaly which led to a failure of the mission. We are obviously collecting data. Shotwell added that there were signs of pressurization and that no safety issues were reported. William H. Gerstenmaier, Associate Administrator for Human Exploration and Operations at NASA, said that it was a tough day. Supplies at the International Space Station are adequate, but there was a significant loss of research equipment, including a spacesuit. Gerstenmaier added that the crew is not in danger.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton said on Sunday that county clerks in Texas who object to same-sex marriage can refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples, despite last week's landmark U.S. Supreme Court ruling requiring states to allow same-sex marriage. The nation's top court said on Friday that the U.S. Constitution provides same-sex couples the right to marriage. Paxton said in a statement that hundreds of public officials in Texas were seeking guidance on how to implement what he called a lawless and flawed decision by an activist court. The state's attorney general said that while the Supreme Court justices had fabricated a new constitutional right, they did not diminish, overrule, or call into question the First Amendment right to free exercise of religion. Paxton wrote, "County clerks and their employees retain religious freedoms that may allow accommodation of their religious objection to issuing same-sex marriage licenses," adding that the strength of any such claim would depend on the facts of each case. He noted that officials who refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples could expect to be sued, but he said they would have ample legal support. Last week's 5-4 ruling by the Supreme Court was the culmination of a long legal fight by gay rights advocates. It unleashed a torrent of emotions both for and against the decision. The ruling was the High Court's most important expansion of marriage rights in the United States since the landmark 1967 ruling in the case of Loving v. Virginia, which struck down state laws barring interracial marriage. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
We're being attacked by news from all sides in tonight's News Blitz. Now we're homing in on Houston, Texas, where NASA announced today that the crew of the International Space Station has successfully completed their 13-year mission studying man's ability to constantly repair a large object in space. NASA officials hailed the remarkable feat of maintenance at a press conference this afternoon.
And throughout human history, man has gazed at the stars and dreamed of fixing something up there. People once thought the ultimate feat in human repair was a really big boat. Today, we've accomplished so much more.
This comes in the wake of NASA's previous success, finding out how many times an astronaut could hold something in his hand, then let it go, watch it float in front of his face for a bit, then catch it again. All right, dust yourself off. You have survived the News Blitz.
Tune in tomorrow morning to Today Now. We'll look back at Jim's week as a polygamist.
Oh, it's going
to
be fun.
This is the Onion News Network.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, kicking off the third hour of this program. You can join us here toll free at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. We've been talking about the situation in Greece. Also, folks have been talking about the Confederate flag tonight, the gay marriage Supreme Court decision, and will that affect gun reciprocity, gun permit reciprocity? There's some speculation that it both will and won't, so you're welcome to share your thoughts here at 855-450-FREE. Ian and Derek J. in the studio. Jackie is joining us first out the gate here in South Carolina. Jackie, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Derek J.
Well, hello. How are y'all doing tonight?
Great.
Good.
Go ahead with your thoughts, please.
Well, I did not fly a Confederate flag until last week, and I busted mine out of the closet, and I threw that thing up on that flagpole faster than you could say whatever, because the whole situation around here is so ridiculous. I mean, it's
What is the situation? All I heard about, again, I was in the woods all week last week, so I don't know why all of a sudden the Confederate flag is so newsworthy. I heard something about someone like shot one down or climbed up a pole and like tore it down in South Carolina.
A couple days ago, someone actually climbed up and tried to take the flag down that they're actually voting to take down. Someone actually physically climbed up there and tried to take it down.
There's a vote? Who's voting?
The South Carolina legislature's voting right now. They say they have enough votes to get it down.
So the person who took the flag down or was attempting to...
I think it was a lady. I don't know.
And that was prior to the vote actually happening. Did that person?
The vote hasn't actually happened yet. Okay. They took a poll and they said they have enough votes to get it taken down. When they do actually go to get it taken down, they feel positive that they can get it taken down.
Which is ridiculous.
It's been up there forever. It does not represent anything that has to do with races. I hate that these white supremacist jerk faces are using our flag to do their agenda, because they're the true racists.
Sure. I understand the frustration.
Why do you feel a sense of identity with this flag?
Because it's about... Okay, America is about the fact that you can go to any state and live the way that you want to live. Every state can be governed by its own rules. When you try to put this one-size-fits-all moo-moo on us, like we're all one-size-fits-all, that's what gets everybody mad, and that's what the Confederate flag came out of. It wasn't about... I mean, yeah, it was about slavery. I'm sure it was about slavery, but it wasn't mostly about slavery. It was about the government coming in and trying to tell the state what you have to do. I mean, I understand there's federal laws and I understand there's state laws. That's the beauty of America, is if you don't like what's going on in this state, you can move to another state and the laws will be different.
Do you think
now
that
the federal government's coming in, they're giving us one size fits all, and it's not working out well.
Has the flag lost its power now that the symbol means so many different things to different people?
Absolutely.
Why use it?
Because you always want to fight for the truth. You always want to show that this flag does not represent racist hate. I hate black people. That is not what this represents. This flag represents freedom, independence. The men that fought under this flag fought because they were sick of the government telling them what to do.
So how do you make sure that people who see when you fly this flag, how do you make sure they know that you're not racist?
Yeah.
You know, I really don't care if they think I'm racist or not, as long as I'm not racist.
Well, I would care about that.
Everybody offends. You know who was really offensive? Jesus. Jesus was the rock of offense. It even says it right there in the Bible. So I don't care. I think anybody.
I would care if my neighbors, you know, thought I was racist. I fly a peace flag out in front of my house, and I don't think there's any confusion about what that stands for. I understand and appreciate your reasons for flying this flag, but I don't. I feel like, you know, I would want to get black people on board with secession too, and maybe flying the Confederate flag might be a turnoff, an initial turnoff.
But I haven't lost any black friends that I have yet.
Okay.
So, all right. Well, I mean, my black friends come over, they see my redneck ways, they see my flag, they love me, I love them.
If there's anybody who can get away with flying the Confederate flag, I think it is a black person. It's always interesting to see, like, I remember Mark told a story about a guy who wore a Confederate flag t-shirt in Florida who was a black man. And so that was kind of one of those weird juxtapositions that I think might get people thinking. That might get someone to ask a question. But when somebody's just flying a Confederate flag from the back of a pickup truck, you know, the first thought that's going to come to a lot of people's minds is that person's a racist.
White supremacists, racist people who use our flag, the Confederate flag, to hold their agenda, which, you know, get your own flag.
Apparently they're not going to be getting their own flag. There's a story here from the AP that the KKK will be holding a rally on South Carolina's State House grounds. And there's a picture of a man in a hood carrying the Confederate flag. Jackie, thanks for the call tonight. You've got a long road ahead of you. Good luck. The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. Dirt J, you're shaking your head.
Yeah, because I don't know why people want to cling to something that has no, at least with a word. You can look it up in the dictionary, and it will have possibly two definitions. And you can fight over definitions, and words' meanings change over time. And you can say, you know, hey, this used to mean one thing, and now it means another. But with a flag, There's the just baggage. It only stands for, you know, one meaning, and that's up to the interpreter. So at the point where a flag stands for something that makes people offended, they're so confused, they think it means racism, stop using it. That's not a useful word anymore. It's not a useful symbol. It's not conveying the message you want to send. If this woman is saying she's not a racist, but she wants to fly the Confederate flag for truth or something, I'm sorry. I don't see that as an educational opportunity. You're going to turn a lot of people off, and there are lots of ways you can promote peace, freedom, independence without saying you're a racist. Like you gave the example of flying a peace flag. You know, why not try a new flag?
Yeah,
why not make your own?
I was just wondering, you know, to myself now aloud, what would be a good secessionist flag? I mean, obviously, you could really go right out there and just put secession now on a flag, and then, you know, it'd be pretty clear what you were standing for, right?
I think it should be the outline of the U.S. with the outline of New Hampshire separated slightly.
Or in this case, South Carolina, the little state of South Carolina sort of coming out.
Yeah.
From the United States. I think that
maybe,
would be clear.
Maybe with a little hand waving goodbye.
Share your thoughts with us here. What's a better design? I'm sure we've got more creative people listening than us. So if you have got an idea for a good secessionist flag, something new, dial in toll-free 855-450-FREE or draw one up and post it on our Facebook page. I'd love to see it.
I think just two hands, the outline of two hands is just hands off. Hands off NH.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts here. Glenn in Philly, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Derek J.
Yeah, a picture of New Hampshire coming out of the U.S. I'm just picturing it like people who want to be deported from the United States. Anyway, about the lady who was got in trouble for her child playing in the park.
Yeah.
Because some neighbor ratted her. This is going to get, you know, much easier, much more common, and much more prevalent as these new software programs get working. You know, the peacekeeper, flash mob secessionist, flash mob, you know, vigilante software. You know, if your neighbor does something you don't like, you just, you know, call a flash mob and then somebody shoots your neighbor for you, you know?
What?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about people, these, when you combine the concept of this woman getting ratted out by her neighbor with these new software they're advertising, like, you know, call and put use this new software and you know, somebody will come and help you. It's not too much of a stretch from that to, flash mobs, phone software being used to produce vigilante flash mobs. If it goes to an extreme.
Seems pretty unlikely. Well, I think people are more likely to want to help someone than to want to hurt someone.
Yeah, but Glenn's point, Glenn's in Philly, and these flash mobs have been happening. They get organized over Twitter or Facebook within the span of a day or a couple
hours.
Yeah,
but are they dangerous flash mobs?
Yeah.
Like the ones that are robbing convenience stores or the ones that are just going and having a pillow fight or something?
No, they're robbing stores.
Yeah, exactly. It's like...
And they start fights. They block off entire streets.
Yeah, that's pretty scary.
Yeah.
But then again, can you defend yourself in Philly?
No.
That's not inside the city. When's the last time a flash mob like that happened in New Hampshire or Vermont or someplace where there's actually the right to bear arms and defend yourself? Glenn, thanks for the call tonight. We'll continue here in moments. Plenty of time for your call and thoughts at 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
Discover how deep your American roots go for free this 4th of July weekend. Go to TryAncestry.com to get free access through July 5th. Visit TryAncestry.com anytime this Wednesday through Sunday, and you'll have free access to our collection of records from the original 13 colonies and with a new visual story experience. Celebrate this 4th of July and take advantage of this free access weekend. Visit TryAncestry.com. That's TryAncestry.com. TryAncestry.com.
All loans subject to OneDeck score approval. Must be business at least 1 year to apply.
Attention, small business owners needing financing. Are you too busy running your business to deal with the slow lending process of your bank? Are you frustrated at the paperwork and delays just trying to get a decision? Then you need OnDeck, the A-plus Better Business Bureau rated small business experts, where our simple application process takes as little as 10 minutes and funding could be available in just one business day. At OnDeck, we focus on your business operation and cash flow, not just your personal credit score. And we're ready to help with loans of up to $250,000. True business loans, not credit card advances. OnDeck provides financing to a wide variety of small businesses like restaurants, plumbing, landscaping, freight trucking, and healthcare providers. If you're frustrated with the paperwork and long decision times of traditional lenders, contact OnDeck. Funding could be available in just one business day. OnDeck is publicly listed on the New York Stock Exchange and has provided over $2 billion to small businesses like yours. So go to OnDeckLending.com today or call 800-293-6819. That's 800-293-6819.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us. The toll-free number that you can do that with is 855-450-FREE or call Skype. Skype username is LRN.FM. Joining you tonight, you have me, Ian.
And Derek J.
And we both have the Peacekeeper app, Peacekeeper 1.0. Unfortunately, there were some problems with Peacekeeper 1.0, and the designers have realized that they need to get fixed. So they're going to hire a new programmer to come in and create an app that has the potential to be world-changing. It is the first alternative to dialing 911. And the idea is that you can indicate on this app, the Peacekeeper app, whether there's some sort of health emergency, maybe a fire perhaps, an abduction. You indicate that and then your friends will be informed. Your neighbors, your friends, other people that have this app that are in your network will be informed. One of the things they're going to be adding to Peacekeeper 2.0 is they're going to make it so that the Peacekeeper alerts that get sent out can actually be picked up by anyone who has the app.
Ooh.
So that's a cool thing because you might not know everybody who's got the Peacekeeper app in your area, and they might be willing to help you too if there's some sort of an emergency situation. But they're going to need a new developer to do this, and they're going to, you know, they're looking to do some fundraising to make this happen. They need your help. They want to show the state what real change looks like, and you can contribute to this at pk.freetalklive.com. Peacekeeper is more than an app. It's a movement. It's a revolutionary system designed to challenge the status quo. It will allow ordinary people to stand up and be heroes, and it'll help keep people safe better than dialing 911. But they need you to get on board and help out. and get the perks that come along with the Indiegogo fundraiser, which you can access over at pk.freetalklive.com. PK, like Peacekeeper, pk.freetalklive.com. Let's go to your calls and thoughts about what you want. Chris is listening in Huntsville to WBHP. Hey, Chris.
Hello. Good show as usual. The Peacekeeper app sounds very intriguing, by the way.
Yes, thank you.
Very nice. Good deal. Well, two subjects tonight. Reciprocity as far as concealed carry. Now, don't get me wrong. The feds should have never got involved with marriage whatsoever. Anyway, should be a local issue or state issue, in my humble opinion. But since they stuck their nose into it and have everything legal in 50 states, other things need to be legal in 50 states and the District of Columbia included as far as carry. Now,
as far as concealed carry.
As far as concealed carry, yes. Mm-hmm. Here in Alabama, we have wide open carry. And some of the states have open carry with no permit, which is the way it should be. You know,
that's how it is here in New Hampshire.
Yes, that's the way it should be. Why should we don't have to get permits to read whatever religious literature, whatever it is? So why do we need to get a permit to carry on with another Bill of Rights amendment?
Mm-hmm.
So, nonetheless, yeah, they get into too much stuff. You know, whether you're pro-gay marriage or anti-gay marriage, no matter, it should have never been dealt with by the federal government. Okay.
I mean, obviously, libertarian types would, I think, say that the government at all levels should not be involved in marriage, that it should be nothing more than a contract between two or more people, and it should be something that, a church will either decide to consider valid or not. You know, a church or whoever would officiate a ceremony should be able to decide for whom they want to officiate such ceremonies, and the state should stay the hell out of it. But unfortunately, the state is involved and has been for decades, ever since basically Civil War times, when the marriage license was, as I understand it, created to keep blacks from marrying whites. So it was a bad reason for the state to get involved in the first place, and it's been worse ever since, because, you know, with marriage comes divorce, which is really the benefit to the state, because then it gets to control even more people's property and even more people's lives. So it's been a real terrible idea to allow the state to control marriage in the first place. So I definitely understand where you're coming from. But at the same time, I also understand why somebody would want the ability, if the state is controlling marriage, to have the ability to have one.
Yes, exactly. Well, a lot of things could go to post-Civil War racism, gun control. That's the roots. The state of Tennessee had passed a law saying nobody could own a handgun unless it was a model 1873 Colt Peacemaker, which was, if you were a black person at the time, that was unaffordable. You might as well buy the space shuttle for all that you accounted for. And so gun control, too, has its roots in post-Civil War racism.
Mm-hmm.
Which was prevalent throughout the whole United States and Confederacy both. Back to the flag, though. The flags used to, in Alabama and South Carolina, flag used to fly over the state house. They were put there in the 1950s, 60s by segregationists. All right, I feel they were hijacked and put there, kind of like the Klan and neo-Nazi groups and skinheads hijack it today. As a compromise, they said, well, let's move them to the Confederate monuments. Alabama did so, and so did South Carolina. And the monuments were put up by veterans, and they were meant to honor the fighting man. Your typical Confederate fighting man fought due to the fact he was invaded after Lincoln's call 75,000 troops to invade the South. Boom, that's when the ball really got rolling. They didn't particularly get into the political realm of it, but that's basically why they fought. Flag honors them. Their monuments honor them. And we made the compromise to do so. Now they're wanting the flags off the monuments. Now they're wanting the monuments gone.
Hmm.
Memphis, Tennessee's trying to remove a grave of Confederate General Nathan Bedford Forrest. It's a grave where him and his wife are buried, wanting to move the monument. I'm almost in favor of it just to protect it, to move it onto private property off of their idiot state property or city property.
I can see where you're coming from there.
Yeah, just to protect it. It's a historical thing. We don't think the same way now that they thought in 1865. Two totally different sets of thought, and we can't put our standards on folks that have been dead 100 plus years.
How much is true?
Impossible. It's really, the deal is, we're of the opinion, we, other folks that honor Confederate heritage, we're of the opinion when we give them one thing, they're going to be after something next. And it'll go until every vestige of that history is gone.
So you're saying make a stand now, protect the flag, the Confederate flag now, or else they'll continue to wipe out any evidence that the Confederacy even existed.
Exactly. And another thing, too,
interesting theory.
It's what they do.
And you're down there. I mean, you're living it, so I take your word for it. Chris, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you.
I don't see why these things couldn't live on in history books. I don't see why a flag has to exist on a piece of state property or somebody's grave has to be there. It seems like, Dave's right, that the state, or Chris, rather, is trying to stamp out the history of the Confederacy. Well, if he wants to survive, it's passed down through your children, through stories, not through flags and monuments. Not my opinion.
Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. I'd like to go on record and say I would like to eliminate the monument to the Union soldier here in Keene, New Hampshire. Mm. I am sick and tired of seeing that thing. It is a monument to war, as far as I am concerned, a monument to aggression. At the very least, you could argue that the southern monuments to the southern troops was more of a defensive kind of thing. But the Union soldier... they were definitely aggressive folks there. So I would like to see that go away. I don't really want to have any war monuments whatsoever, honestly. 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts here. This is Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
It's a terrifying thought. You're trapped somewhere without a radio and no access to GCN shows, a doctor's office, the DMV, your mother-in-law's.
Come on, stay for dinner.
That's what makes the newly redesigned GCN Live app a true lifesaver. Listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programming on your smartphone, wherever you are. Download yours free on iTunes or Google Play. The new GCN Live app. Don't leave home without it.
Uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies. That's what the readers of FreedomsPhoenix.com get every day. FreedomsPhoenix.com constantly providing the information, the real news about government policies, and the real relationship we all have with the coercive government. The real condition of the economy, innovations in technology, breakthroughs in energy, health, and computer science. Learn the truth well before it's admitted to in the lamestream media. The corporate media, nothing more than distributors of government propaganda. But now there's an alternative. FreedomsPhoenix.com. Constant news updates on the issues that affect your life in the most important ways. With liberty and property under constant attack, FreedomsPhoenix.com provides the understanding behind the propaganda, and it encourages the participation of its readers. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com. That's Freedoms with an S, Phoenix.com. FreedomsPhoenix.com. The revolution between the ears has already happened.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Pure Life Water, helping you drink better and live better by providing a zero-calorie alternative to sugary drinks. Visit us at nestle-purelife.us. When kids are playing, they often don't want to stop to keep hydrated, so send them out with a bottle of water and encourage them to take frequent drink breaks or call them inside for a quick sip. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. And you can Skype us at Skype username lrn.fm. With you tonight, it's Ian here.
And Derek J.
And Derek J's website, thederekj.com. Coming soon, oodles and oodles of Porkfest video.
Mm-hmm.
You recorded a few hours worth, 2 or 3 hours worth of video.
Yeah, there's some semi-naked men in there too from Flaming Freedom.
Will that go up on YouTube?
Oh yeah, I got exclusive video. They're not completely
naked.
Not
naked enough. Okay, because yeah. There was one naked guy during Flaming Freedom, at least one man who was full frontal, full on naked.
Yeah, I guess I missed that.
You missed that?
Whoops.
It was pretty obvious, but it was actually the military guy. Oh. Which was interesting. We actually interviewed him on Free Talk Live earlier in the night.
Wow.
And then he took it all off during Flaming Freedom.
Oh, okay. Yep. All right.
So pretty cool. And I took some pictures of Flaming Freedom as well. I don't know if you're going to be putting those online
yes.
at some point. Where will those show up?
Flamingfreedom.com.
Excellent. Excellent. So yeah, you'll get to see all of the depravity from Flaming Freedom. All kinds of people getting tied up and semi-naked. And there's never been anything quite like that at the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
No, it was unique. And you can see some video at thederekj.com, so thanks for the plug.
Yeah, and more coming later. You're going to start uploading tonight, right?
Yeah.
So, thederekj.com, go there. And, of course, you also blog over at freekeen.com. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. First up, Jason is listening in Utah to KZNU. Hey, Jason.
Hey, guys. How's it going today?
Hey, welcome. Good. Go ahead.
Hey, I grew up in the South, and
me too.
You know, I never flew a rebel flag because I always knew that it just basically meant you're a big redneck, and I get it, you know, that it's offensive to people, but the reality of the rebel flag being banned, don't you guys think it's kind of like the Mockingjay and Hunger Games? It's a symbol of rebellion, because every Southerner knows that the rebel flag basically just means a big fat middle finger to the federal government. So what do you guys thought?
I mean, I guess I see where you're coming from on that, but maybe not every Southerner knows that. Maybe some of them think it's a redneck thing and that it's not really so much a middle finger to the feds as it is a redneck symbol. I mean, you know, do you think everybody flying the rebel flag from the back of their truck really understands the historical detail behind what it stands for? Or is it just that they like to go mudding?
Yeah, I guess I should preface that. I think Southerners that know their history, know the real side of history, know that. But you're right. There are people that just like to, you know, crush beer cans on their forehead and ride around.
How about a new rebel flag, which has the logo that Davy Barker designed with it's got the word rebel on it. And then the B in rebel is the Bitcoin symbol.
Yeah.
I think that one's a little more powerful.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. Hey, I had a question for you guys. I was thinking about the chilling effect of having, whether you support the rebel flag or not, but just having it disappeared from, like, Google. You know, if you type in, you know, Confederate flags for sale, it doesn't exist on Google.
Really?
And I think that's pretty, yeah, try it. Try, you know how on Google, if you type in something, it'll show you images and then web and the news and then for sale. It doesn't exist. And that's really chilling to me. So I wanted to get you guys' thoughts on that. And then what are some alternatives to not supporting, you know, companies like that that don't believe in the First Amendment? I'll just hang up and listen to you guys. But
wow, that's interesting.
You know, do that exercise. It's really scary.
He's right. Yeah. I just tried both Confederate flag and rebel flag, and you cannot use the shopping option on Google for that. Huh. Jason, thanks for the heads up. I appreciate it. The toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. What was the – there's this new search thing. I need to get in the habit of trying this new thing. There's I was checking out the latest version of the Tor browser recently, Derek J.
But no, I'm sorry. I'm still stuck on this. How could this be? This caller is completely right. I just checked it on Google. I mean, Confederate flag did not match any shopping results. How is that possible unless Google is censoring shopping results from Confederate flags from appearing? Because I see there are vendors who sell them. If you do a Google web search, you can see stained flag or whatever .com. Yeah, so they are for sale, but Google won't show you where.
Yeah, I wonder if it's...
I don't like that.
I wonder if that's a coincidence or if that's they decided to do.
I mean, what? Does Google see it as some sort of endorsement of a flag that they point you toward where they can be sold? Because, I mean, they sell flags on eBay that are made out of that look like ISIS flags that are made in the shape of dildos. So, you know, that's not an endorsement by Google of a particular flag, be it ISIS or gay pride. So, you know, why would they prevent someone from getting a Confederate flag? It's very confusing to me.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, there's a possibility that it is a coincidence. Okay, so let me explain what I mean when I'm saying that.
Okay,
so Google Shopping is only going to index certain websites.
Yeah.
So there's some sites it does not index. So I guess the ultimate test of this would be to find a site that we know is indexed by Google Shopping, right? And then see if there one of those sites has the Confederate flag in their inventory.
Yeah, what about eBay? eBay results
point.
Always show up on Google Shopping.
You're right. In fact, I just typed in ISIS flag. And actually, I can't find the ISIS flag itself. There's the F ISIS flag and the F ISIS T-shirt. And yes, a couple of these things are on eBay. So yeah, that's a good point, Derek J. This may be an actual
choice.
This is
an intentional self-censorship by Google. And yeah, I share the caller's concern. While I don't think it's smart to fly the flag, while it offends people, it's confusing, you should have the right to go find it on Google. I don't think, you know.
Well, you don't have a
That's
right.
Not very
it's
nice.
Their private service, right? And they can tell you, they can decide what you can and can't see. But
yeah, yeah, no.
Maybe there's
you don't
a
have
search
a right.
company that can do it better. Maybe Google is on, you know, maybe it's at its peak. Maybe Google is not going to be number one forever, right? I mean, there's a long history
of... when you start preventing people from finding certain search results and your whole operation is based on giving people search results, yeah, maybe they are at their peak if they're turning around... did not match any shopping results. This
right,
is
and you've
insane.
Got them pulling certain results from Google in Europe. I don't know if you remember that court case where
no.
there was an international.
Oh yeah, yeah. Like if politicians say, "Oh, we don't like what is coming up when you Google my name,"
or
so
just anybody apparently
get rid of that link.
Yeah, so that's kind of scary. So anyway, well, just what I was going to reference here, Derek J, is and maybe another option. Now I'm not taking a side on this. I don't have an opinion about this website beyond I'm curious.
Yeah.
There's in the new version of the Tor browser, they got the little search bar up there, and there's mm-hmm. a newish search company called disconnect.me. Have you been to disconnect.me?
No.
So I'm thinking this might be like the new cool search because, well, it's in the Tor browser and you know, just because of that, it's probably pretty cool. But I did go and take a quick look. Essentially, it is a kind of a privacy-oriented search company.
Okay.
You're being hacked and tracked, it says on disconnect.me. There's a web of invisible trackers on many of the websites you visit and apps you use. Unsecured connections and hidden requests for your personal info leave you vulnerable to privacy and security threats. We show you what's going on and allow you to block the hackers and trackers. Your sensitive personal information, identity, and passwords are vulnerable and being tracked by cyber criminals, companies, and governments when you're online. We route all your internet activity through our encrypted tunnel, which prevents wireless eavesdropping, secures your connection. Sounds like a VPN, actually. I'm not real sure what these people are doing. There's some kind of a search thing going on here. All right, I'm confused. I don't know what disconnect is. If you know what it is, you can give us a call here, 855-450-FREE. They call themselves Online Protection Simplified.
Yeah, but it seems like it's an app. It's not just a website. Like, you have to download software.
Keep your searches private. Your typical searches are not private. Search engines and thousands of other companies save your personal searches and may associate them with your real name. We anonymize your search queries and let you search privately through your search engine of choice without being tracked. So in the Tor browser, there's a little searchy thing for this disconnect.me. I guess I'm kind of new to this thing. I don't know what it's really all about. But yeah, it does sound like a competitor to ProXPN. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. I'm not real clear on this thing. We'll come back with more here. Your calls and thoughts will sneak them in the remaining moments of Free Talk Live coming up next.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. zog.ninja. Code FTL.
Hey guys, I'm Tim Baker.
I'm Daniel Brown.
And I'm Sean Stewart.
And we are the You, Me, and BTC podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
Us three chumps love to talk too much, and for some reason other people seem to enjoy it.
That's why we started You, Me, and BTC,
which is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Find our show at youmeandbtc.com every Thursday.
We also post Bitcoin-related reviews, opinion articles, and much more.
Subscribe, like, and follow at youmeandbtc.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here. If you're on the line, we'll do our best to get you in here. But it's like the typical Free Talk Live situation. Everybody decides to call in the last 15 minutes. Just a hint. If you call earlier in the show, you'll get more of a chance to talk about whatever it is you want to talk about. When it's the remaining moments like this, we always feel obligated to try to hear from everybody. So that means you don't get as much time to really explain yourself. So 855-450-FREE is the number. Our Skype is username LRN.FM. Derek J. and Ian in the studio. Let's just jump right back in here. Zach is on the line in Minnesota on the amp lines. Hello, Zach.
Hey, guys. I'll be brief. I called in when you guys were looking for an alternative to the stars and bars. And I would offer to those folks who think they're flying it for that reason, why not some Revolutionary War options? You know, the classic Gadsden flag, the yellow don't tread on me, or even the incorrectly named Betsy Ross flag with the 13 stars in a ring. That's a symbol of secession as good as any other, and you're not going to piss off half the people that you think you're sending a message to.
Great point.
Yeah, I'll give you that. You got any new ideas, though? Like new? I was looking for something fresh.
Well, yeah, as far as something new, I mean, you just it's a symbol like any other, so, you know, as good as you can make a, you know, I guess I don't have any off the top of my head, but...
That's all right. I have one, just a black flag with the white text NEMO, which is Latin for nobody.
I didn't know that.
Nope. I would be careful with the black background and white letters these days.
What is that? Why? Oh, yeah, never mind. ISIS.
What, ISIS?
Yeah.
Don't let them own black backgrounds and white letters.
Okay, what about, I don't know.
Thanks for the call, Zach. Appreciate it. Let's talk to Nathan. He's in Fort Lauderdale. You're on Free Talk Live. Nathan, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, guys.
Hey, welcome.
How you doing?
Good. Yeah. Go ahead.
Good. So, you know, I actually met you at Coins in the Kingdom back in October of last year.
Cool.
And, and unfortunately, I missed some of the people here. But, I fly a flag of the South. I'm actually a Canadian citizen, but I'm flying one just because I believe that anyone who censors free speech, you know, should have that back in their face in any way that, you know, we can bring it to them.
You don't think that some censorship is a good idea? Like,
zero.
Okay.
You know,
well,
I mean,
now wait a minute. Isn't censorship generally a term used when it comes to government restricting freedom of speech? You can't generally use the term censor accurately, at least, to describe, say, what we would do here if you were to say the F word.
That's censorship.
Is that
in my
censorship?
View.
Is it still censorship? I always thought that it had something to do with the.
I wouldn't think it would be because you're private. You know, you're a private organization that has the right to censor or allow whatever you want, right?
So, is there a different word for that when it's done privately as opposed to done by governments? I consider it all to be censorship, and I think some censorship is good.
Yeah, I guess you're right, Derek J. I mean, there's not really anything specifically in the definition of censor that has to do with. With the government, although the number one definition does say an official who examines books, plays, news, reports, motion pictures, radio, television, etc.,
yeah,
for the purpose of suppressing parts deemed objectionable on moral, political, military, or other grounds. So you could extract from that that the word official suggests someone in government.
It's just, though, I don't want people in government to dictate my behavior. So in other words, I don't want to do the opposite of what they say I can't do. Like, right, if they're like, you can't fly a rebel flag, and then I'm just going to go fly a rebel flag just to...
Well, that's what Nathan's doing.
Yeah, well, it's like, aren't you letting them dictate your actions? I mean, you wouldn't do this otherwise, right?
Yeah, you have a good point.
That is a good point.
Regularly, I would just fly a black flag for anarchism and, you know, and free speech, or maybe perhaps no flag at all because, you know, I don't believe in admiralty jurisdiction when it comes to the flag, which really what it stands for is the admiralty jurisdiction, like the law of the high seas is what these flags stand for. You know, and you talk about the union really is probably one of the worst abusers of freedom worldwide. You know, they have 160 military bases worldwide. How many hundreds of millions of people has the American government killed in the North compared to, you know, perhaps the South?
Nathan, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Let's talk to Mark. He's in Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Mark.
Hey, Ian.
Hey.
I was just going to say that, you know, when two sides are warring, wouldn't it be great if, like, their leaders had to do pot first? You know, wouldn't
if they had to smoke pot?
Yes.
I'd rather they take a dose of MDMA, personally. I don't think that pot is necessarily going to lead those government goons to have any kind of pang of conscience. But I think that if they took some good, clean MDMA, what do you think, Derek J., would that be a good thing? I mean, if, you know, Barack Obama and Mahmoud Ahmadinejad were to dose up on some MDMA, would that help bring world peace?
I don't know. I think it couldn't hurt. MDMA has a tendency to increase a person's empathy. So if these world leaders, so-called leaders, are suffering from a lack of empathy, that may help them see an alternative way.
Mark, we're short on time. Thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. I mean, not that I would oppose them taking a toke off of a peace pipe, too. I think that's a fine idea. But I think that MDMA is a very, very powerful drug in the direction of bringing people together. And it can, you know, break down barriers in your own mind and break barriers down between people. And
yeah,
it's one of my favorites.
But I don't think that, you know, so if these dictators who are waging wars are, you know, if they're interested in making wars happen or sending other people off to fight, then I don't think they're going to be persuaded by taking a drug. I think that they might
probably
be more persuaded by going out onto the battlefield themselves, having some risks, something at stake. You know, that's what's going to change
their
mind.
I'm not saying one dose of MDMA is going to make somebody who's a warmonger into a peace, peace advocate, but it couldn't hurt.
Yeah.
Let's go to Straight Razor. He is in Texas. Hello, Straight Razor. You're on.
Hey, so this whole flag debate, instead of talking about what this flag is all about and everything else, how about the local governments or any governments stop spending money on these flags to put at memorials. Stop spending my money.
Yeah.
Just stop.
Yeah.
Because
like
all of these memorials have to be kept up. So all these statues have to be cleaned.
Right.
Oh, that's okay. We get prisoners to do it.
That's ridiculous. Just stop spending my money.
That doesn't cost you anything. We'll get the people who are in jail to do it.
Well, they still have to pay for the damn statue in the first place. The people in the jail aren't making the statue, right? Somebody's paying for that.
That's an idea. Get them on it.
Straight Razor, good call. Thanks for making it tonight. I'm sorry we're short on time. Let's get John on the line here in Indiana. John, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yo.
I have to call earlier next time. I just wanted to thank you guys for the coverage of Porkfest. It was really great. I was there with you in spirit and hope to make it there next year. It sounds like a really awesome event all the way around.
You should come next time.
Mark your calendar now and start telling your friends so you can bring more people up, because the more the merrier. It's always fun. I can't imagine going to Porkfest as a road trip could be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Well, I just found out about your guys' network recently, and so I'm really excited to have done that and be following you as much as I can here now. And just got a bunch of points to make, not enough time, so I have to call again. But I guess, to sum it up for where I was wanting to go in a moment, would be I have a T-shirt that shows a broken light bulb on it, and it says, "Censorship is the assassination of an idea." So I just wanted to throw that out there.
Is that what?
Censorship is the assassination of an idea.
Oh, that's cool. Thanks for the call, John. Yeah. I appreciate it. Let's talk to H. Reardon in Tampa Bay, Florida. H. Reardon, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, I called to say that I think this idea of replacing the rebel flag is not going to work because, for example, someone mentioned the Gadsden flag. There are people involved in the Tea Party who carry Gadsden flags to rallies.
Yep.
And people who are opposed to the Tea Party have associated that flag with the Tea Party.
That's true.
But it doesn't really matter. It doesn't matter what you do, what kind of flag you have. People are going to be offended by it. People are going to catch on that you've replaced it with something else. So none of that is going to work. The bottom line is nobody has a right not to be offended. It doesn't matter what kind of flag you could have. You could have a flag that's just a plain orange flag, and somebody would find some offensive meaning in that.
You're right. I mean, I think I got nothing I can say to pick that apart. I think that's true. However, that doesn't mean that I'm going to try to rescue the rebel flag, right? Like, I don't think that's worth my while. What do you think?
Well, fine. If it's not worth your while, it's not. But it might be worth it to somebody. You know,
everybody's entitled. I mean, I really hope the South rises again, man. I wish them the best of luck. I just don't know if that's going to make it happen. Hey, thanks for the call, H. Reardon. We're out of time for tonight. I'm all in favor. Bring the South back. Secede again. Do it peacefully this time. Don't fire on the fort. Of course, the argument is they didn't actually fire on the fort. That was actually a false flag, but that's another story. See you tomorrow night online. In the meantime, at freetalklive.com. Check out Derek J at thederekj.com.
Hi. Do you ever say, "I could care less," when you really mean the opposite? You mean to say, "I couldn't care less." It's a common mistake. You are judged by how you speak, especially if you're looking for work, with so many more applicants than openings now. But even if you're not, avoiding common misstatements will help you make the most of the dozens of conversations and transactions that crowd your daily routine. So whatever you say, don't say "whatever" as a single word sentence. It's the most annoying expression in the American English language, according to a recent poll. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. But seriously, at the end of the day, you'll want to avoid this scenario, sounding like everyone else. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, June 29th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.89 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $256. Antiwar.com reports with the June 30th deadline just a day away, there is still no official word on a new extension of the interim P5+1 nuclear agreement, though both U.S. and Iranian officials are confirming that negotiators are planning to remain in Vienna beyond the deadline to continue the talks. It's not unusual for this to happen in the lead-up to a deadline, as officials often try to play hardball at the last minute and claim the deadline this time is firm, though each time they eventually all concede that the talks are just too complicated to wrap up in time, and that more time is needed. A six-month extension seems the most likely result, as it would push the talks toward the end of the year, giving more time for talks. As with past extensions, this is sure to spawn a new round of condemnation from congressional hawks and foreign factions opposed to the nuclear talks, notably Israel. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports the Falcon 9 reusable rocket from SpaceX on Sunday suffered its third failed fiery attempt to launch for outer space and return to land on a drone ship. NASA held a joint press conference with SpaceX representatives about the rocket's failure. SpaceX, owned by Elon Musk, launched the Falcon 9 at 10:21 a.m. on Sunday. The main objective of the mission was to deliver a SpaceX Dragon capsule to the International Space Station as part of a $1.6 billion contract with NASA. SpaceX President and Chief Operating Officer Gwynn Shotwell said, "Up until 139 seconds into the flight, we experienced an anomaly which led to a failure of the mission. We are obviously collecting data." Shotwell added that there were signs of pressurization and that no safety issues were reported. William H. Gerstenmaier, Associate Administrator for Human Exploration and Operations at NASA, said that it was a tough day. Supplies at the International Space Station are adequate, but there was a significant loss of research equipment, including a spacesuit. Gerstenmaier added that the crew is not in danger. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton said on Sunday that county clerks in Texas who object to same-sex marriage can refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples, despite last week's landmark U.S. Supreme Court ruling requiring states to allow same-sex marriage. The nation's top court said on Friday that the U.S. Constitution provides same-sex couples the right to marriage. Paxton said in a statement that hundreds of public officials in Texas were seeking guidance on how to implement what he called a lawless and flawed decision by an activist court. The state's attorney general said that while the Supreme Court justices had fabricated a new constitutional right, they did not diminish, overrule, or call into question the First Amendment right to free exercise of religion. Paxton wrote, "County clerks and their employees retain religious freedoms that may allow accommodation of their religious objection to issuing same-sex marriage licenses," adding that the strength of any such claim would depend on the facts of each case. He noted that officials who refuse to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples could expect to be sued, but he said they would have ample legal support. Last week's 5-4 ruling by the Supreme Court was the culmination of a long legal fight by gay rights advocates. It unleashed a torrent of emotions both for and against the decision. The ruling was the High Court's most important expansion of marriage rights in the United States since the landmark 1967 ruling in the case of Loving v. Virginia, which struck down state laws barring interracial marriage. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. Starbucks begins its sinister phase two of operation. This is Doyle Redland reporting. After a decade of aggressive expansion throughout North America and abroad, Starbucks suddenly and unexpectedly closed its 56,423 worldwide locations today to prepare for what insiders call phase two of the company's long-range plan. Cynthia Valcant, Starbucks head of marketing, made this brief statement at a press conference earlier today.
We have enjoyed furnishing you with coffee-related beverages and are excited about the important role you play in our future plans.
Existing Starbucks franchises across the nation have been shuttered with high-strength titanium, and the well-known Starbucks logo has been slightly altered to present the familiar mermaid figure as a cyclopean mermaid whose all-seeing eye forms the apex of a world-spanning pyramid. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
Welcome to Liberty Conspiracy Radio on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM. If you are streaming us over the airwaves, thank you for tuning in or for offering our programming on the Liberty Radio Network.